Well, you know, he's had a go and you think it's now or never.
I was watching James Wilson earlier on playing Dennis Nilsson of Sweden, and the Swede knocked him out. And James was saying he took 9 darts and missed all of the doubles with all 9. It just happens sometimes.
It does, it does. And it's very frustrating. In my match this morning, I shot a 135, ball treble 15, double top. And then the next leg, I had 12 darts, a double top and double 10. And you just think, what's going on here?
It's not my day.
Absolutely.
100. Michel van der Horst was all smiles after his last 16 victory. Here, he's struggling to get off the mark. 85. But maybe Pantelidis there, not sticking the knife in just as much as he could have done.
Well, this... 140. Oh, good darts there. This competition is one of the last. It's the last ranking event of the year to qualify for Lakeside. And Michel is one of those that's right under the pressure. He's right on the cosh of... right on that edge of making it or not making it to Lakeside. So this is a big tournament for him, and he's done well to get here under a lot of pressure. He's now got to try and get some points from this match, but it's not looking good for him.
No, the 39-year-old Dutchman is struggling here against Kostas Pantelidis. First to 5 legs. You can see that on your screen at the bottom here. And the horse would just love one at the moment. 80. Costas, you require 26. 4-0, Scott, and this is nearly all she wrote.
He's got to go 5 now. Yeah, double 4. 18. So this is if he's going to get back in this game, he's got to take this.
Game show on the fourth leg. Oh, a sigh of relief, I'm sure.
There does. As a player, there comes to a point where you just think, do you know what? I can't keep missing these. The law of averages says I hit one, and you go and hit it.
Well, Van der Horst, a quarter-finalist of the Swedish Open, quarter-finalist of the Antwerp Open. Struggling to get past those quarter-finals at the moment, and at 3-1, he'll be mighty relieved because he was not far away from being 4-0 down here. Pantelidis, though, coming back.
140. Which is what you've got to do against the darts. You've got to punish those soft and slow starts. Put Michel's back there now.
Playing for some 31 years, he was telling us a little bit earlier on. And he now needs to find all of that experience because Pantelidis, as you said there, Scott, punishing the bad start.
He has, and Michel's now having to chase the game on his own leg, which is one after he's just stolen. He would fancy coming back and asserting himself on the match. But now he could be staring 4-1. In the face here.
And against the throw as well, if it's 4-1 as he moves into that. 100. Another ton from Michel. Triple 20. Oh, it's way off there.
Oh, a bit wild. A little bit of a flyer, I think we can call that.
69. Michel van der Horst needs to find something good here.
That's a good start.
Treble 18.
Treble 18. Oh, he stayed there. I can understand why. But a good recovery. So pressure on the 67. Oh, look at that. Now he's got to go 14 ball. Bullseye. 42.
And the horse sees the door just come open again here to staying in this Romanian International Darts Open. And he's got it from 3 down. Now just 1 down.
Now the young man from Greece has got something to think about. Because he's been bossing this game in his head. And now he's got to try and stop this sliding.
Perhaps he still needs to stop looking at the crowd, who are all in fancy dress here in Romania. They were giving it away as they made their way in the paying public. And they've all donned it. Hats, wigs, you name it.
Yeah, there's some good stuff out here, I've got to say. Some stuff that I haven't seen back in the UK, that's for sure.
For anybody wondering, me and Scott are not in fancy dress. We always look like this.
Yes, yeah. Probably looks fancy dressed to everybody from over here, though, mate.
2013 Greek runner-up is Kostas Pantelidis. Can he be Romanian semi-finalist? That last one again, just off the mark. And Van der Horst from Deventer near Amsterdam has nailed the 180.
Indeed, it's like a big turnaround here. You know, he stole a leg there to go 3-1. And then, you know, he's staring 3-3 in the face here, Pantelidis.
55. Michel van der Horst knows he's coming back again from 3-0 down. Will be giving us a wonderful comeback already in this first of our men's quarterfinals. There's been some great action here in Romania. And 24. Michel just unable to finish it off here.
That was a really bad last start to be going back at 1-1. Straight down into the 10. 95. Duly punished. So it'll be one up and one in. That's what you say at the pub. Okay, two up and one in. The result was just the same. We're back at 3-3. Back where we started.
But now Michel is level and has the throw, and that could be a deciding factor as they go into this. If Michel can hit this double treble, he has. Pantelidis now will start to feel the pressure that Michel van der Horst was on just three legs ago.
And it's turned it into a best of three shootout for a place in the semi-final.
May as well have just turned the cameras on now. 60. Didn't need any words.
Well, I was just looking for the, I was looking for the camels.
I was tempted to say the winner of this will be taking their money to the sand bank, but I won't.
No, it'd be far too silly to say that, wouldn't it?
Pantelidis now could do with a big 95. Big score. 95 keeps him in touch here.
And that 60 will see van der Horst in charge of that leg. Pantelidis now knows he's got to hit two trebles to stay with him.
The pressure has really turned round in this first quarter-final match then. Michel van der Horst, for the first time in this quarter-final, chance to take the lead.
65. He knows he's coming back. So Pantelidis will look to put pressure on that.
It must play on your mind. 3-0 up, back to 3-all. And now 4-3 down. Kostas Pantelidis will not be happy with himself. There's a question to our referee.
Now. What's gone wrong there? He's obviously thought it was best of 7. So it looks to me, could this be a turning point for van der Horst? He thinks he's won the game now, mate, mentally. He thinks it's done.
There's a lot of mental issues going off in this game.
That's mad, isn't it?
30. Oh, welcome to the Romanian International Darts Open. If you're just tuning in, where the norm isn't the norm at the moment. But here, Michel van der Horst has clawed himself back from 3-0 down. I think the announcement earlier was that it was best of 7. It's not, it's best of 9. And maybe these two misheard that.
100. Well, it doesn't seem to have affected van der Horst.
And Pantelidis finds something big in the time he needed it most. 140. Another big three here from Kostas. 55. I'm going to help in a great position there, Scott. And then a 55 to follow it up.
It can happen. It can happen. The 180s are great, but you've got to follow it with something.
101 left for Michel van der Horst. Again, Pantelidis, if he can get himself a decent area, and he has done. Now again, pressure back on Michel. He can win it here.
Yep, double top for the match.
Oh, from 4-0 down, 3-0 down, should I say. Michel van der Horst was one double top away from taking it. Pantelidis
going 16 for double top.
Yeah. Oh, he hasn't.
Where did he head off to there?
Michel Pantelidis taking a diversion, shall we say, to win that leg. And Michel van der Horst says, just you wait a minute. Antelidis, he has every intention of making this semi-final. He hasn't had the best of starts, but he's had the greatest of starts to this final leg. Antelidis not letting him go. Chance here for the Greek.
Again, just what we were saying earlier. Got to back him up.
41.
He's got away with it. He's got away with it. Really needs a ton now.
Real tip for tat here. Big score, big score. Miss.
Oh, good last there. He just actually overthrew that and laid it on the top of his first two darts.
And now, Costas, just to the side of the treble 20. But he's again putting pressure on Michel van der Horst.
Oh, again, he's done that dart again. Just flipped it over the top and used the barrel. Pressure now. Another one of those.
What pressure?
He missed it before. Is he going to get it now? Yes.
Well, 3-0 to Costas Pantelidis early in the game. But Scott Mitchell, we have seen a very good comeback from Michel van der Horst. A little confusion over the amount of legs. He thought he won it at 4-3. It let Pantelidis in, perhaps that confusion just slowing Michel van der Horst down. But when it mattered most, the 39-year-old from Deventer in the Netherlands has made his way through to the semi-finals.
Ladies and gentlemen, this
is the 2014
Romanian International Dance Open, coming to you from the stage here in
Bucharest. Welcome back to all the viewers. Little Richard on the stage, your host.
International Tennis Finland Open finalist. It's Sami Santi.
And out comes Sami Santi. I was stood at the desk, Scott, and they were asking all of the competitors, what music do you want to come out? And I tell you what, it was a real eclectic mix.
Yeah, we're quite a strange bunch, I think, where the musical tones are...
Nobody said One Direction.
No, I don't think we'd have gone that route, to be fair. Probably half of us don't even know One Direction are, so... particularly
oh,
over here, maybe.
That's a lie.
Well, OK, I've got to deny it, haven't I?
Live on air, you have. So, Sami Santi of Finland... We'll allow little Richard to bring on his opponent.
His opponent is from Scotland. Welcome to the stage, Chocolates, Paul Coffin.
Chocolate Paul Coughlin, 35-year-old from Dundee. There's a few Scots here who'll be enjoying Paul Coughlin's introduction. Winner of the Hungarian Open this year and also the Latvia Open in 2013, so knows what it's like to win away from home shores. Not sure in those three countries, or the two countries he's won his titles in, would know that song very well. But they'll perhaps know the name Paul Coughlin, and they might know it a little bit better after this one. Sami Santi, on the other hand, he's lost in the last 32 of the Czech, Danish, Swedish, German and Dutch Opens. He's managed to make it to the last 16.
Indeed, yes. Yeah, Sami's one we've known for a while. He's been at Europe Cups and he's been at World Cups before. I've been out and played in the Finland Open and met Sami on a few occasions, and Sami's travelled to... Sami's then sort of like gone to some of the bigger Cat A's, so we know what Sam's all about. He looks more like a power builder than a dart player, but a good dart player all the same.
Well, if Paul Coughlin's first visit is anything to go by, Sami will have to be. Sami Santi, that's the man on your screen right now, as Scott say, he's a well-built fella.
As most of us are. You know, there's nothing wrong with that.
appetite for darts, shall we say.
I think that's what they call it. And with Paul here, Paul Coughlin, he's sort of been on the circuit this year. And as you say, he's won at Hungary, he's won at Latvia. He's boxed a little bit clever, gone to the slightly lower ranking tournaments, but got further in them. So that's put him in the mix for the Lakeside run. And this will do him no harm today as well. He's there and thereabouts, right on the outskirts. I think this would help him today, big time.
Plenty of tactics in sport, and you're quite right. Paul Coughlin using his noggin, shall we say, to get himself around Europe and pick up some valuable points on his way towards the Lakeside.
I'm not sure. I think this may be his first time on TV. I don't remember seeing him on TV before or even commentating on him. So this may even be his TV debut. And on a 140 to start, he'd be pleased with that.
Not too short of a perfect start and a perfect TV debut for Paul Coughlin, but can get somewhere near a checkout. He's got plenty of room here, Sansi 215.
That's 80 to start. Will he stay there? Yeah, he stayed there. Are we looking to get somewhere? Leave it, Andy. He did more than leave it, Andy. He gave himself a chance at double. I couldn't see whether that was in there or not on a monitor.
Slight underestimation there. Scotty was all about going for it.
So, yeah, he's gone down the 19 route. So now he can't get out. 112 left. He'll either go big 20, which is risky, or 12, I would go. There you go. Left himself double top. So there's a certain amount of pressure on here, but Coughlin will be looking to hit this and settle himself down.
As you say, a perfect TV start for Scotsman Paul Coughlin. He's already seen off Ferenc Oliver in the last 32. In the last 16, he was a 4-1 victor over Danny Noppert of the Netherlands. So he's working his way around a fair few international darts players. And now, Sami Sansi is the person that stands in his way. As good a start this time for Coughlin. Can Sansi punish him?
100. Yeah, good scalp for Paul Coughlin, Danny Noppert. Danny's been around for a little while in the Netherlands, doesn't travel too far, but he's one of the top boys over there. So he's done well to beat him, and a good win. It was 4-1 as well, round before this. And Sami Sansi beat my England teammate, Glenn Durrant. So, and Glenn's been on fire this week, so another good win for him.
Yeah, Glenn going down 4-2 in that last 16 game. Darius Lebanowskis of Lithuania was the scout for Sami Sansi in the last 32.
Well, we'll see Darius at Lakeside as well. He's making his debut, so that's another good scout for Sami.
85. The pair of them just showing a few jitters in this second leg. Not as swift as the first here for Paul Coughlin until that moment. Pressure on Sami.
Absolutely. I mean, that's putting him right back in the leg. So Sami needs a treble here. Here we go, downstairs. 59. Paul requires 76. So, chance for Sami. Going back at 74, it'd be treble 14, I'd have thought. Yeah, 14, so 20 for tops. Double top.
Well, that big 180 from Paul Coughlin didn't help him out any in the end. Sami Sansi rescues it, and they all stay with the throat.
It would help him out mentally, mate. It will, because he'll be happy that, you know, he's comfortable with the throw and he's found the 60 on a regular basis. So it will settle him down, and he will be happy with that. But, of course, he's now got Sami that's now got his first double under the belt and his first leg on the board. And it's a fear when you go up there. You don't want to be beaten to nil. And particularly when you're new to TV like these two guys probably are.
It's part of the art trying to switch off from thinking or even contemplating what the other.
The part of the art of this game, mate, you've got to not think. The minute you start thinking about anything, you're in big, big trouble. Other than looking at the board and throwing what you're looking at and look at what you're throwing at, really.
25. Coughlin finding one dart out of the board, and only 25 for his troubles as well. So Sammy Sanzi will see the first opportunity.
It was a really poor first out from Sammy there, but he backed it up with the next two, and he seems to have found his range. 60. It's just unlucky there for Paul. That bounce out has now left him 70 behind.
And the 60 won't have got him any closer. And Sammy, another 100. So with plenty of breathing space, Sammy Sanzi requires 80.
Here we go in treble 20, I'd have thought. Double 10. Double 5.
Making his own pressure then.
Indeed, I think he wouldn't want to have left 5 there, so he went a bit tentatively at the 2 5s, knowing that Paul was on 161. And Coughlin, another one of those, and he's now left big pressure.
Sammy looking out into the crowd, perhaps trying to ignore, as you said, Scott, everything else going on. Just dealing with this, and he's dealt with it.
Very well. Very well he dealt with that, because that was good pressure from Coughlin. And, of course, now he has the advantage of the throw, so that could be a big break. As I was saying, arts and costumes we're not used to seeing in the UK.
There are two big opera houses here in Bucharest, and I think some of the people watching have come straight from there.
Yeah, one few hundred yards out the door, isn't there?
Just outside the hotel. Here in the Intercontinental Hotel in Bucharest. Once called Little Paris. Bucharest, famous for its wide tree-lined boulevards, marvellous buildings, and a reputation for the high life.
Well, indeed.
And you can add a fancy dress to the list.
And you can add fancy dress to the list. And I believe this was the first 5-star hotel in Romania. So, yeah, bit of history here with the hotel.
Home of the perm and of whatever else takes your fancy. Paul is allowing Sammy Sanzi to take control of this match at the moment. He's won it against the throw in the last leg, and Paul's last three darts didn't put enough pressure on Sammy Sanzi, who gets that last dart just where he wanted it.
Sammy seems to be taking control of the stage. He's not being rushed into anything he doesn't want to do at any pace that he doesn't want to do. And you can tend to be chase a little bit quicker than you usually would when you play on the floor. So he's 25, so it's treble 20. He'll stay there, another treble 20. 65. So he's left on 56, so Paul's really got a dent in this. He's got to put a dent in it. 34. Not quite what he'd have ordered.
A mere scratch from the dent that Scott was asking for. Sammy Sanzi.
Double top.
And now has a 3-1 lead here in this men's quarter-final of the Romanian International Darts Open. Who will follow Michel van der Horst into the semis? And look at this for a comeback here for Coughlin.
Respectable averages there. The first 9 dart usually is a... average is a lot bigger than the actual running average, because you want to get off with starts like ton 40, ton, and put pressure first 9 darts. So that's why the first 9 dart average, and you can quite clearly see that Paul's trailing there, and that's the reason that he's 3-1 down, because he hasn't put any under any pressure at the start of the legs.
Chocolate Paul Coughlin will hoping he's not melting under the lights here. Sammy Sanzi looks as cool as a cucumber.
Yeah, Sammy does look as cool as a cucumber, even when he's blown his top. Sammy's been around. Sanzi's been around a long time. All the time that I've been on the circuit, the 6 or 7 years I've been on the circuit, he's always been around. And he's going in on every bit of that knowledge at the moment.
Obviously at 40, he's much older than you.
No.
I was helping you out.
You were. But the wife is watching, so I can't lie. Otherwise, she'll be phoning up the station.
40. So you require 160.
Just away from stealing this one. Paul Coughlin has to now watch and hope it's not a 4-1 lead.
It's a good second dart. And an even better third. So Coughlin's now under the pressure on his to hold his throw.
Got to hold his nerve here. Got to hold his nerve.
20.
And hasn't. So just 20. Bouncing under.
This will hurt. It's a double 10. Indeed. Always hurts when you've had three darts to hold your own throw. And obviously it's Sammy Sansi's throw now as well, so Paul's got to really regroup here. And he's not being given the chance.
No real breathing space here for Paul Coughlin. We saw a tremendous comeback in the first of these quarterfinals. Paul Coughlin's got to come up with one himself. 96. He's hanging on. Can Mr. Cool finish the job? There's the door, slightly ajar.
It is slightly ajar. But this will be both good for Coughlin because he will learn an awful lot from this, whether he wins or whether he loses. Paul will take an awful lot from this game. And that's going to help him, in hopefully for him, the near future at Lakeside.
Well, he's helped himself massively there. 140 after Sammy's 60, and now a 45 from Sammy Santi. It's a long way back for Paul Coughlin, but come back, have to start somewhere if he can take this leg.
39. I'm wondering if Sammy's a couple of furlongs out here and he can see the winning post. And he's clobbered into the first fence, unfortunately. Forgot it's there. So he really needs to get back into that treble 20.
100.
Just like that, and the last dart always hurts.
In his mind, Paul would have been just saying, miss, miss, miss.
And every time you say that as a player, it goes smack bang centre. So you learn not to do that too often. You get your head out of that situation. Sammy needs another treble. Oh, that's unfortunate. Just caught a flight.
You're, of course, speaking from somebody with wonderful experience of playing and winning at the top level. Maybe somebody of Paul's ability or at least experience hasn't quite worked that one out yet.
Yeah, but I mean, I didn't work it out on my first go. So it really is brilliant for him to be up there doing it.
Could be the end of his journey here.
96.
Yep, good thinking from Sammy. Obviously, wanted to leave top, so he's consciously gone that way. So, 72, he goes another 16. Double top. Oh, 36. No, he's gone that way.
Sammy,
well.
40.
Well, he went a different way to what Scott Mitchell thought he was going to. He might be going towards the exit here. One. Good dart from Sammy Sansi.
Oh, he's leading. Oh, the shoulder went in. You could physically see the shoulder went in. He dropped in on that one. And he's putting himself in big trouble.
Only 18. If Paul Coughlin finishes it off. And he hasn't either. Well, these two can smell the semi-final.
I can only think Coughlin went that way to leave the 36 because he prefers it. And he now missed it. So it's double 16 for the match.
Well, it probably lasted slightly longer than it should have done. Sammy Sansi had chances to finish that off earlier on. But Paul Coughlin of Scotland, as Scott was saying, it's a television debut, we believe. He's got himself into the quarterfinals, couldn't quite get any further. The semi-finals just out of reach. But Sammy Sansi will meet Michel van der Horst of the Netherlands in the best of 11 semi-finals a little bit later on in the programme. We'll see you in a couple of
2014 Romanian International Darts Open, coming to you live from Bucharest. And we now continue our men's quarterfinal matches and introduce firstly to the stage a Czech international, Michal Ondaro.
Where are
Mikael Ondo. He introduced himself to me as Michael earlier, so we'll try to clear that confusion. We'll, for the benefit of us, we'll call him Michael. That's what he told me his name was. 29-year-old from the Czech Republic, born in a town called Vysoko Mito. Don't ask me where it is. I've just figured out how to say it. And Michael Ondo, another one that looked quite calm and relaxed this afternoon.
His opponent is a Northern Irish international. It's Gary Elliott.
Gary Elliott. He won't like me for saying this. I asked him how old he was, and he had to literally think for at least 30 seconds. He said 38, and then he went, or am I 39? I left him at that. So we'll just say he's nearly 40.
Well, yeah, I think that covers it.
From Ballyclare, he's Gary Elliott. Which I don't think is the same place those two are from.
No, actually, they're from the Czech Republic. So, yeah, probably Michael fans.
So the last 16 of the European Cup. Gary Elliott, his teammate Kevin Benes, here in the Intercontinental, here in Bucharest.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Our third quarterfinal, best of nine legs, is Mikhails of Rovers.
Seems to have got away from that slight confusion earlier on. With the amount of legs, it's definitely first to five. And it's Michael Ondo who shows a sign of perhaps a little bit of nerve there. Just dropping one of the darts.
Well, I do know a little bit about Ondo, actually. He knocked me out the singles in the Europe Cup. So I'm having a right one here so far today, aren't I?
I wasn't going to mention that.
But, yeah, no, I didn't know a lot about him until, yeah, he... As one of my fellow friends, Mr. Bobby George, would say, he beat me up good and proper. And I found his game was very solid like this. He was a treble 20 hitter big time.
177.
Well, Michael Ondo has just told Gary Elliott he's got a contest. What can Gary Elliott return with?
85.
Ondo conquered Wales' Martin Phillips in the last 32. A 4-0 victory in that one. It was a little bit closer in the last 16. Ikesdal Kjetil of Norway was the opponent. 4-3. So Ondo scraping through. Good first start here from Elliott.
100!
Could have done with another one. But he's not too far behind.
No, he'll be happy with that. He'll be happy with his start, his first nine darts. Ondo's going to be happy with his here. 82. Is he going to go the ball route? Or is he going to have treble 14? He could go the ball. Looks like he's looking at the ball.
129.
Missed it. But that was the way to go.
Left himself 73, Ondo. Elliott will know he needs to leave himself a finish. And those first two.
55.
Added with the third. Haven't put him in the strongest positions.
14 then for double top. Double top.
Held his nerve. Michael Ondo, you can see how much it means to him. Screams, the first real scream of excitement from any of our players so far. And it's into the third quarter final we are. Elliott now needs a strong start to this second leg.
I know that Ondo won't be rushed along.
96.
And at the same time, he won't be slowed down. So, because I tried both when playing the other day.
No is laughing it? Matter whether you've got bunny ears or not.
These are Ondo fans, they're fellow Czech Republic players. Have been here for the Europe Cup. 99. And they'll be pleased with the way their man has started in this quarter final. Elliot still finding his feet. 55. He's all over it, and they're just not dropping in at the moment. You start to think about that.
As you said, Michael Ondo, knocking you out of the European Cup. Got to the last 16 of that. Would want to be out of the last 16 into the quarterfinals of this. He's done that. Now, can he make semi-finals? 60.
He also beat Wayne Warren, actually, before he played me as well. And so if he's beat Martin Phillips today, he's having a right old go at the Welsh, isn't he?
I'm sure there's nothing meant by it.
No. No, you just try and beat whoever's put in front of you.
Absolutely.
Good last for him there. Now then, that's better from Elliot. 100.
You require 139.
He'll be looking for a few more visits like that.
Ninety-nine.
Good big safe, big 19 there to leave himself double top. So Elliot will be trying to pressure that. First dart was good. The third dart was good. So, it's the double top he hit in the first leg. He's now going out for the second.
Ondo to make Elliot say, oh no. Or will he allow Elliot
double
a bit of breathing space? It's Ono from Ondo. Again, you can see how much it means. The man from Visoko Mito. Two up here in Romania.
He'll be pleased with his finishing because he's visited the board on two occasions. With darts in his hand to win legs, and on both occasions, he's won them. And that's what settles you down. When you're not used to this stuff, that's what settles you down and makes you feel that, hey, I should be here.
You've got to feel part of it, haven't you? You've got to feel like you belong.
Yeah, take other things into account as well. The guys have obviously been on the floor maybe till sort of 4 o'clock or whatever time, and they may have had a two-hour break now where they've been, you know, trying to grab something to eat or calm themselves down and then return and try to play how they were when they left 2 hours ago, and that's very difficult.
When you've done a mammoth morning session as these guys have, and it was well run and well put together and everybody wasn't too far out of the schedule, but what do you do with that gap? There was a big-ish gap between the last games of the 16 and the quarterfinals. What would you do?
Well, obviously, me going out first round, I've had a huge gap. But, you try to use the time to your advantage. You try not to think about the time. You pop back to your room and just have a sit down, watch a bit of telly and grab a bite to eat, rejuvenate a bit of energy and come back fighting again, really. And come back and have another good practice for half an hour before you play.
It's perhaps not one of those sports where you just go away and look at your opponent and think, oh, this is what I'll do. You, like you said earlier, you just go and do what you do.
You go and do what you do. You don't think about 100. An opponent. You think about what you're doing, and because you can't do anything about what they're doing. You can be going 140, 140. You can be going 180, 180. And you could have done all the reading up you like. You wouldn't have expected him to do it. So 80. When you get to these last eights, you've got to give everybody the credit they deserve that they've done something to be here. They've done something special to make this far in the tournament, so.
Well, as we say, Ondo has beaten Phillips and then Kettle from the last 32 and 16. That's why he's here. Sean McGowan and Colin McGarry were on the victims list of Gary Elliott. Fellow countryman Colin McGarry knocked out 4-1. Sean McGowan beaten 4-2 in the last 16. And Gary Elliott was beaten by the Swede Dennis Nilsson in the World Masters in the early rounds. And Nilsson was the man who scalped James Wilson earlier on today. Jammy Dodger's run came to an end in the last 32. Nielsen was then pushed aside by the man we saw first up, Michael van der Horst. 58. Really is one of those where anybody can beat anybody. 1-5-2 here for Elliot.
So that's a good start. Another treble 20. Oh, he's missed it. Is he going to stay there? 92. No, off to the 12s. It's getting used to where the new players go, or the players that you haven't seen so much on the TV go. We all have our strange little quirky ways of going. This one should be straightforward. This should be another treble 20. He's missed it. He'll stay there. No, he's gone down.
Gary, you require 60.
60 to put Elliot within half the distance he was a moment ago. Game and he's done it.
Gary Elliott. Full play, Gary to throw first.
As I said earlier, Elliott conceded two legs to Sean McGowan in the last 16. He's done so here already to Michael Hondo. And the
48.
Near 40-year-old Gary Elliott claw back another leg and square us all up here. Our last quarter-final was easily won by Sammy Sansi. The first one was a tight one. What are we going to get here?
Well, that was good adjustment from Hondo. Really poor first dart, and then whacked the two treble 19s. Gary Elliott replies as well with a treble 19 of his own.
100!
Ton up for Hondo.
Nobody quite getting their grips onto it at the moment. It's the game seems to be just
100.
Just ticking along.
Yeah, it is. It's just ticking along like a bomb waiting to go off.
95.
Well, there'll be a short break after the fourth leg of this game. Maybe, just maybe, these two will regroup, gather their 60. Thoughts, and come back hitting a bit stronger. Here, Elliot knows that Hondo requires 122.
100.
He now requires 92.
So it'll be the 18's route. Yes, he'll stay there. It's the bullseye.
86.
But he's hit at 14, so he's left himself.
He was halfway down. 36. He thought he'd done it.
He had a bit of a lurch on. Strange way that for Gary, with the man on the double, would have thought he'd have gone for the ball. First start, but here we go, on to 136.
Didn't gamble, Elliot.
Ooh, that's a nervy dart. That's a nervy dart. He knows it. He knows he didn't throw that right. He's taking a step back, going back in for double nine. That's a better dart off the barrel.
18.
Well, tried to compose himself there, Hondo, and didn't manage it. And he's, you can see him in the background. He is not happy with himself, and he'll be even more annoyed here if Gary Elliott can level us up before we go to the break. He can. He can. And that means it's two apiece. So when we do come back in a couple of moments, it'll be all square here at the Romanian International Darts Open. So a short break here at the Romanian International Open. Not quite enough time for you to make a cup of tea. But maybe enough time, as myself and Scott were saying a moment ago, for Hondo and Elliot to just calm themselves. Just had a few practice darts. So does a break affect you mentally?
Huge. It could be huge, depending on where the game is. I mean, obviously there, for Elliot, that was a great break because he really stole the leg. And Hondo's had to wait there for 2 or 3 minutes to think about what he's just given away. And that does play on your mind. For that 2 or 3 minutes, you can't think of anything else that you should have had that leg. So, yeah, the breaks can be really big. But on that instance, I'm sure Gary would have loved that break.
We start with essentially a stalemate, two apiece. First to five here at the Romanian International Darts Open. Bucharest has been buzzing for bullseyes, was the sentence that somebody gave me earlier. Maybe, just maybe, we'll get a few of those here.
I was here in January for the Romanian Classic, which I won, and it was minus 15 outside here.
So it wasn't buzzing. It was, you know, it was frosted eyebrows job. I've never had a tournament where I've had to wear a T-shirt under a shirt sort of thing. But
we'll change it to breezy bullseye bashing.
I think that'll probably do it. And then today we arrived and did a bit of team bonding on Tuesday morning, and we got absolutely drowned. It just rained and hammered and hammered. So I've had two experiences here. So, but it's been good weather since.
Lovely here at the hotel. They give you a card of a bit of paper every morning and tells you the weather for the day and the night and whether it's going to rain or not. And the lucky for us, we landed and they put a big tick next to sunshine. Been around about 22, 23 degrees here in Bucharest today.
We seem to have come back where we left it, really, before the break. Nobody really trying to... Overtry, maybe, is probably the word to get a grip on the game.
As you said earlier on, maybe these two would feel a bit of pressure trying to make a semi-final. Would feel a pressure trying to make sort of mark on the...
I think it's a case for a couple of the guys. I mean, it's not like they're playing Scott Waits or whatever. You know what you're getting. Probably Ondo and Elliot haven't been on TV much at all, if at all. So they're probably still taking notice of each other rather than getting on with what they're doing, which can be a thing that you do on the first attempt. Right, we've got a 21 there. 89, what's next door? He's got it. It's double 16.
It's going to be a big moment for Ondo.
78. Gary require 115.
Just away from a wonderful finish.
That's treble 19 now. Top. So.
To stay with the thrower then. Ondo to make it 3-2. Does it. And the big scream again. There is a biggish contingent from the Czech Republic here. And you've just heard them. There's the flag. There's the fans.
And there's the hair.
Yeah.
Yeah, they've been fully behind him this week during the Europe Cup. I think Michael's been their star. And I was on the under end of a couple of those screams. That's just how he does it.
That man with the large specs getting a closer view of the action here. Intercontinental Hotel. Five-star hotel. These two just trying to find their five-star diet. Ondo's, he's changed tact altogether.
133.
And he's not doing bad out of it.
Well, no, we saw him struggle at the top there when we come back from the break. And, yeah, he's gone southport.
140.
As a boxer would. In the art of combat. And he's finding some success down there.
Elliot just reminding him he's still here. But one more of these.
133.
Well, he'll be thinking, why didn't I start down here?
But he's going to have to go up the top now. So he's got to find something from a bit of confidence from those last two. Elliot's gone a bit wayward here.
140. Okay, then.
60.
Another unconventional way to go, but getting him nearer where he needs to be. Elliot will be looking for a treble 20, and he's way, way off 60. It at the moment.
Michelle, you require 80.
Treble 20. Tops. And again, the big scream from the man from Isoki Mito. And you can't hide his delight. And a few raised eyebrows.
No, not at all.
4-2 with the throw for a place in the semi-finals here. And he's sticking with those 19s. You can't blame him, Scott, after that last leg.
95.
A lot of people are frightened to do it. A lot of people are frightened to do it because, you know, the traditionalists and how they usually play, they just stick away and plug away up there. But Michael's been not frightened to do it, and he's reaped the results from it. He's reaped the results from it. So if there's any young players out there watching, you know, don't feel that you have to stay up there. You know, you can come down and have a little dabble down there on the 19s. Get huge confidence, like Michael Ondo is.
I grew up in a public house with a dartboard, and it was abnormal to see people just starting with 19. So it does exist, and here, Michael Ondo is making a good bit of business out of it.
It's sometimes to do with height. I know Richie Ashdown's a big one for the 19s, or a little one for the 19s, could we say. You know, that would, you know, it tends to be the shorter players that tend to go for the 19s.
Eye line.
Indeed. 95.
Something that Mr. Elliott there will have been happy he found in that last dart. But he's got to find something, because at the moment he's rocking. 59. And he's going to be packing his case sometime soon, unless he comes up with something big here.
Indeed. I mean, I found that strange move from Ondo there. He was left uneven. And once he'd hit the 19, I thought he'd stayed there, but there we go.
Another drop dart with two of those we've seen.
42. He'd be disappointed with those. He'd be disappointed with the last leg and a half with Elliott.
Problem he's got is he's already shaking his head, and we're still in the game.
44. He is in the game. Ondo doesn't seem to be getting away from him at the moment. Here we go. He's back in the game now. Another one of those.
83.
Millimeters the wrong side for the Northern Ireland man, and it's 113. So he needs that treble 19 now. He's hit it. Double 18.
Well, Michael Ondo has got a dartboard tattooed on his arm. He'll have thoughts of victory tattooed inside his brain now. He's into the semi-finals. He's seen off Gary Elliott. Well, Scott, the change of tact from Michael Ondo as we go into this break will be something me and you will discuss, and maybe we'll see it again in the semi-finals. But Ondo, he certainly changed the ideas. He had the break, came back, took it on the chin that he wasn't the best.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the 2014 Romanian International Darts Open as we look to complete the men's quarterfinal here in Bucharest.
Welcome back to all our viewers. No, don't adjust your sets. The crowd are indeed in fancy dress.
And a host of three world ranking titles. He's a former Grand Slam of Darts, Wimbledon World Masters, and Lakeside World Champion. It's Scottish in Aussie, Scott Waits.
So on comes 2013 World Champion Scott Waits. Adds some weight to the semi-final. He was by far the biggest name to make it through to the semi-finals here. People have been asking for pictures, autographs, and the odd hug from Scott Waite. And their wait is over. Kim Virenen will be coming out next from Finland. Will Scotty be too hotty for the Finn? We're about to find out.
We now introduce a former WF World Cup youth champion, a Finnish international, Kim Viljanen.
Viljanen, out he comes. Former youth champion, as Little Richard was telling us, and the conqueror of somebody pretty close.
Yeah, he conquered the guy that beat me. I was destined to head Kim's direction. Had I got through my second... Have I got through my first game, I think? First or second game?
Yeah, steady on, first game.
Yeah, I got to get through one first, yeah. After a couple of three games, I knew that I was heading towards Kim's direction, so... I can get a good look at him now.
So can he, through those specs. As you can see, the Romanian contingent here. And anybody else that's joined us aren't having a bad time. The two players will be warming up. So you know Scott Waite pretty well.
Yeah.
That story. Tell us
no,
the
No, no, I'll tell you the real one. we've been rooming together this week, obviously, as part of the Team England Europe Cup team. And, we were put together as roomies. And we've known each other a long time now. So sort of back since 2006, 2007, so... Yeah, once you room with him, though, you do find out a little bit more about him. Messy devil.
He came over and gave us some encouragement during the first game. He was think he was trying to pull us off. Wouldn't like that if we went over to the dartboard and did that to him, so we won't. As we went to the break here on Eurosport, we were asking between ourselves if Scott Waite has got this nailed on, this Romanian International Darts Open, and you look at the contestants around him, but of course no sport is won on paper.
No, it's not, and Scott will be fully aware of that. He's probably been at this situation before and been the red-hot favourite and bombed out, so he will be treating every single player with the respect that they deserve, and at the same time not taking a lot of notice of what they're doing, but the way that Scott plays.
He's made just two finals from 15 tournaments that he's entered. He won the Police Masters as part of one of those. Since being the world champion, is that because everybody's out to get you all of a sudden?
I think people's persona to play you changes. You know, they relax a little more. Kim's not relaxed here. Look at that.
My. Kim Vilhanen says Scott Waite too.
But this is exactly what we're saying. You know, Kim has no fear, but when you play the top stars, this is what they do back to you.
Yeah, that 180 might have done something to some of the contestants who we've already seen in this quarter-final stage. But I tell you what, Kim Vilhanen, he's had a good rest, and he's cleared his mind, and he's just taking on the challenge in front of him.
41 after 12, he'd be over the moon with that. This is what the man does. Stays with you nice and close.
Well, there's no hiding from Kim Vilhanen.
He's gone 9 for double 16. He's having a good look at it. Good and controlled, that. Very good and controlled. Well, he won't be happy with that, opening out with that.
And again, Vilhanen just steps up, slams it in the treble 20. The next two didn't do the job that the first one deserved, backing up. And, well, when it's not going right, doesn't go right. And Scott Waite has seen one of his darts spiral out of the board and hit the deck.
Well, that was a comprehensive 14-dart opening leg from Kim, and he seems to have taken a lot from that, which he would. He's just 14-darted an opening leg on TV against the 2013 world champion.
Nerves, what nerves.
Exactly.
He's already seen off Dave Smith in the last 16, before that Roman Abuchov. And now he's got Scott Waite firmly set in his sights here.
So we know he's played a bit of youth darts. So he's not going to be inexperienced, Kim.
He's a last 16 finisher of the Finnish 2014 Open. Again, he's one stage better off than that today. He's not happy with that 45. He shouldn't roll his eyes there. Scotty needs a little bit of support, and that'll help him. And he doesn't seem pleased with his dart at all here.
He's just not having the little breaks that he needed. And that's a fantastic setup from Kim. So Scott needs a 137 here to get some sort of command back.
And the upturned left part of the lip, as you look of Scott's weight there, tells you again frustration getting through. And Kim Vilhanen punishing and takes the second leg with the third leg to throw for him as well. Maybe that conversation we had was far, far too early. So again, there'll be a break after four legs, and if he carries on like this, Scott Waite will need it.
Well, he's come up here and just started to boss the stage. Scott's got to start doing a bit more of this, otherwise he's in big trouble.
If you knew nothing about darts and just tuned in, you'd think that Kim Vilhainen was the 2013 world champion.
he's looking all part of it, to be fair.
It's not changing, is it?
Dart legs to open us up.
But as you said earlier, when you play somebody of the ability of Scott Waite's, you get those sort of comebacks.
Most days they tend to step up to the challenge. Like he did the other night when he had to iron my shirt before the banquet.
I can't believe you've got an iron.
Oh, he has.
140.
That's great darts there. So 170. That's probably the only thing he's missed so far, isn't it? And he's in there, treble 19.
He's shown some impeccable darts. And he's done a job there to make himself close enough to a finish that Waite needs to finish here.
So 20 for Bullseye. Bullseye it is.
Oh, and Scotty Waite. He breathes a sigh of relief. The English fans here in Romania breathe a sigh of relief. Kim Vilhainen wasn't far away there from making it 3-0. We might be going to the break all square, though, because Waite has the darts.
How's that going to affect him?
100. Well, we saw somebody go off like a rocket in the first game. Konstantinos Pantelidis, or Kostas, went 3-0 up, ended up losing 5-4. 100. Here, Kim Vilhainen showing the old no-fear strategy.
Yeah, and that was a 12 darter from Scott against. Shows the class of the man and right on the commentator's curse. Couldn't hit two bigger sevens if he tried.
Thought you said he was mate.
Yeah.
Well, ain't it? 96 from Kim. From just outside of Helsinki. And you can see the frustration here, and perhaps this break after this leg might just do Scott Waite some good.
But it is frustrating. It is frustrating. He's just gone, done the leg that he's done, feels he's got his everything's back on song, and then all of a sudden the wheels are falling off again, you know.
60 from Vilhainen doesn't punish Waite too much though. But it's wayward. You can see him talking to himself, giving himself a lecture.
It's the right pitch, he's just got to get the right line. 95. Which he did with the second dart, but he was disappointed he didn't follow it with the third. So Kim now really... A 60 here will not help him. 97. Fantastic.
So, Bradford-born Scotty Too Hotty. To try and get as close... 94. To getting this to two all as he can.
A good last-ditch treble there. That was a good last-ditch treble to let Kim know that he's not going anywhere. You can
visibly see the relief in Scott Waite's face. And Vilhainen.
It's just blow by blow. It's blow by blow, isn't it?
Just repetitive, isn't it? He's constantly saying to Scott Waite, I'm not afraid of anyone here.
Double 12.
91. Just.
Double 14, sorry. Me and my maths. What do I know about counting?
Got a bit of paper in front of you and everything. What do you want?
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I'll have to get me the shot calendar out. Double 10.
And he's missed his finish here, Vilhainen.
That was crucial. He knew that was a crucial to take a 3-1 and then have the darts when he came back from the break. So you think this is a must for Waite. Double 7.
As we go to a break in a moment, it's all square again as it was the last time. Well, it was two apiece between Ondo and Elliott, and Ondo came back after this break and smashed his way to a 5-2 victory. Will one of these two do it? Vilhainen, early lead here in this last of our quarterfinals, but it's tense here in Bucharest. We're off for another break. So, welcome back. Bucharest is... on tenderhooks here. We expected to see Scott Waite's name heading towards the semi-finals, finals, and possibly edged onto the trophy quite easily when we took a look at the quarter-final draw. Kim Vilhainen of Finland has thought completely differently.
Well, we could only say he's a calm customer, and he should be from where he's from. I've been very impressed with him. Scott would have known about Kim because we played him in the pairs. And just sneaked by. So 4-3, I think I remember the game. So, you know, this will be no shock to Scott, and that would have been an advantage to him. And Kim maybe feels a little bit settled because he played Scott before already this week, so...
Well, Scott has used the break very, very nicely. 180 to return to the board.
Well, the break, you know, before the break again, it was a no bad leg by any means, but that was the scrappiest leg of the game. And Scott's won it. So then the break is good for Scott if that happens. Unfortunately, Kim had a couple of minutes there to think about how he's lost probably the scrappiest leg of the game.
You feel momentum in sport, don't you? He's got two legs under his belt, back to back, come out of that break with a big 180. He will now feel like the momentum has shifted towards him.
But I'd have been happy coming back with an 81 from a break. You know, you've hit a treble, you've come back and you think you're okay. And then Scott comes in with a 180 to just let you know, it's all still on, my son. It's all still on, I'm still here.
Always interesting to see the facial reactions of the players. And again, you saw their weights clearly. Doesn't feel like he's giving it everything he can. And that last dart from Vilhainen was useful.
Last couple of days, he has struggled with the cold, Scott. But here we go. Double 10. No struggle about this. This is a bit of experience. Step back. Have a good look.
Boom. You said he's got a cold. That's not to be sneezed at all. What a finish there. He started brilliantly, that leg. He finished it even better. And he doesn't want to be the pantomime villain. Waits now with the throw. He's starting to show you the Scott Waits that is a world champion.
He's done a great job to hang in there. I've got to hand that to him. And he's hit some big darts to hang in there. But these games can to and fro. Even though it's only first to five, they can to and fro and ebb and flow. And it has just turned Scott's way from 2-1. But there's no saying it couldn't go back the other way. Because, I mean, see little things like that. That glance off the flight just turns your head a little.
Vilhainen needs a ton. 96. Or close enough.
I'm still very impressed with him. He's staying very calm. He's still staying very composed. He's not rushing. He's doing everything you expect him to do.
A bit like Michael Ondo earlier. He's not afraid to just go to other areas of the board either.
No, I couldn't agree more. I'm quite impressed with Kim here. No matter what the outcome, he's definitely one to look out for.
Well, he's not out of it. Look at this. Kim Vilhainen. Cool customer indeed. He was two up. He's found himself 3-2 down because all of a sudden Scott Waits has started to find the measure of it. But as Scott next to me is saying, he's not letting it go.
No, and I mean, this would be a break as well for him. So what does that do for the confidence?
All around the building here, you can just feel people holding their breath and thinking, hang on a minute, is Kim Vilhainen going to do this?
Here we go, treble 13. Oh no, he's gone treble 17.
95.
So, left his favourite 36.
Will he get chance to come back? Vilhainen cools the fingers. He's cool enough. But he will now start to feel a bit of pressure, but not too much. Kim Vilhainen against the throw levels up against the former world champion. Well, we said earlier on that Romania has given us some random stuff throughout the course of the day, and it just keeps on giving.
Yeah, there we go. Look, there's the number of legs.
60 there from Vilhal. Interesting, I just watched Scott Waite in the background and he sort of gave Kim Vilhain the look of, how do I get rid of you here? This might be a way. It's certainly a good start. Somebody should go on as soon as that third one went in. But he won't go away, Kim Vilhainen, and he isn't. In fact, he's matching him.
But it's his leg. He doesn't want to give it up. You know, there's no way that he wants to give this up. Look at the averages there. That's a better game, isn't it? Both 101s off the first nine. 97 overall for Scott. Just dropping back to 96. And 96 for Hyland. It's just...
Well, he wasn't looking at the board when that treble went in. He was when the second one went in, though.
Marco Cantelli there. Watching. Fellow Finn.
He needed that last one. Really needed that last dart. He's got a bit of breathing space here, Vilhainen.
That is a super last dart. That is a super last dart. All Waits can do now is try and pressure this shot with a 180.
Steering. A 4-3 deficit in the face here, Scott Waits. Vilhainen to rock Bucharest here. Maybe, just maybe, we have found his nerve.
This is a big shot for Scott. He's going for that treble 18 again. He hasn't got it. It's only 36 scored. 68 left. He'll go treble 12. 72. He's left himself a double. But again, will he get back? So it's Kim again. Double 9. Surely down the barrel. Now he's got two barrels to aim at.
Well, Kim Vilhainen. If somebody had offered you a chance of three darts and a double to go 4-3 up in the quarterfinals against Scott Waits, he'd have bit your hand off. And now he's 4-3 down himself.
And they hurt because you can just see there that was right in the corner. You know, it's not smack bang centre. He's had two right on that double 9 wire. This game is crazy mental in your head.
Welcome to darts, where the norm gets thrown out of the window. Scott Waits must have felt he was going 4-3 down there. Three darts and a double for Kim Vilhainen, who's looked so, so comfortable.
Solid. He's looked solid. He looks comfortable. He looks like he should be there. And until those last three darts at a double there, he's done nothing wrong, really. He's done nothing wrong.
Maybe, but this is the difference. Flap, yeah.
This is the difference between those superstar guys.
And again, Waits, the perfect moment to put more and more pressure on here.
The pressure started to throw before when he hit the treble 20 with the last dart. But this is good. But he's just chasing now. He's in autopilot, Kim. He's just chasing now. Hoping upon hope that Scott makes a mistake and he can then get in and capitalise. So there's the mistake. Mm. Scott's realised it. There's the mistake. Really needed a treble there.
Three different attempts at trebles. Three narrow misses. Will it be close enough to let Kim Vilhainen in? And he's done exactly the same thing. Three different areas of the board.
That throw mentally was totally different for Kim, because that was his chance. He's staring it down the face, and now Scott will just go and hit two treble 20s. There you go.
Scott has seen his let off and gone straight back at it.
Absolutely.
Vilhainen has to come up with something big here. Waits with 64, and Vilhainen hasn't done enough there.
Double 8.
Well, if he misses this, he'll still have three more at it. 48. And he'll need those three. But Kim Vilhainen had an opportunity to be in the commanding seat and be 4-3 up. And he'll know that. And that's, as you say, he's just now throwing very comfortably. Because he knows, surely, Scott Waites won't miss all three as he did. And I said surely. Because he hasn't.
He knows he's come by a tough opponent there. Good arts, fat lad.
Roommates, friends, banter givers, if you like.
Ladies and gentlemen, as they leave the stage from Finland, Kim Vilhanen.
Well, Kim Vilhanen is getting rounders of applause, not just from the fans. I'm sure people at home are sort of saying to themselves, yeah, he is somebody we need to keep an eye on. Because when it comes to playing tough opposition, he wasn't found wanting at times.
He's a definite one for the future. There's one to look out for. The Scandinavians produce them, and they keep producing them, and we keep seeing them. And look at those averages, 95 and 93. Good darts out. Good
two game. 180s from Kim Vilhanen, who nearly just international darts open. And I've got Scott Mitchell sat next to me in the commentary box, and he's just giving a round of applause and a thumbs up to Kim Vilhanen, who's just put in a fantastic shift against Scott Waites. But he couldn't complete the job. Waites makes his way through to face Ondo.
And we're going to welcome to the stage for this first semi-final a man from the Netherlands, a semi-finalist in the Romanian Classic earlier this year, now a semi-finalist here at the Romanian Open. It's Michel van der Horst.
So van der Horst was 3-0 down here, Scott, in his quarter-final. Konstantinos Pantelidis had him on the ropes, and all of a sudden he fought back, and he fought back hard. As the song says, he wasn't going to take it, and he didn't.
Different customer this time, he's got different customer altogether, a lot more experience.
From Finland, twice a Finnish Open finalist, it's Sami Santi.
I'll tell you what, little Richard, who's your MC, as you saw and heard on the screen there, he's a braver man than I am, calling him the big man. But Sami Santi of Finland, the 40-year-old Finn, was our first real cool customer. 5-1 victory over Paul Coughlin. The chocolate melted. What can Sami Santi do? He'll have taken note that Michel van der Horst was capable of going 3-0 down. Santi will know that. I'm sure van der Horst has given himself a talking to as well since that quarter final.
Yeah, Michel is quite a cool and calm character, and Sami can get quite fired up at times. So it's a chalk and cheese sort of thing, but Sami seems to be taking a new look at how he's playing. And he used to be quite quickly and play with a lot of anger, and now he seems to have calmed himself down, and he's obviously playing better. Otherwise he wouldn't have been here.
New technique, new strategy, not doing him any harm. It's interesting, the pronunciations of names as you go along in your career as a commentator. I actually asked Michel van der Horst, what's your name? And he said, they call me Michael. And I said, yeah, what is your name? He went, it's Michel. And I went, do you mind if I call you Michel? He went, no, not really.
Indeed.
And yet, as you said to me first thing, everybody calls him Michael, but there you go.
Yeah, we do.
He calls you Michelle, though.
Yeah, he calls me Scott Michelle. Works for me, it's fine.
Santi. That composed stare. And he gets himself a 99 to start with. Cool as the ice cream, the flake went in.
26.
Well, not the start or follow-up to the start that you would have wanted there.
100.
And it's just solid here. As you said about his physique earlier on, his data matching it.
Well, we do get the timber sports here on Eurosport, and I'm worried. I'm wondering why Sami hasn't tried that. I reckon he'd be good on one of those big cross-cut saws or something like that.
Right about now, I think he could throw a rather large caber right down the middle of the board and that would hit what he wanted. Although, as you say about commentator's curse a little bit earlier on today, we've done it again. Michel van der Horst, he He needed that first dart.
He is. Again, under a lot of pressure, Michel, because we know he's chasing that lakeside spot, and every round that he goes through 59. Gets him half a foot in the door and a step closer.
It was around about the mid to high 20s in the BDO rankings, Michel van der Horst. And he'll be wanting to go back to Deventer in the Netherlands, a little bit closer to that lakeside competition.
And this is a tough place to come to this Romanian Open to get points this time round. With the European Cup having just been here, most of the guys have stayed on. So, you know, you've got the best from their countries all representing them. And it must be tough to come in, because Michel didn't actually play for Holland this week. So he's come in on the cold, and this is his one day here. So he's done brilliantly, no matter what happens from here.
Yeah, been eyebrows raised at some of the results all the way through this, not just in the last 32, but in the prelims this morning, as you yourself found out. People were hungry this morning.
They were indeed, and yeah, it took a big bite out of me. So, double 14. Double 7.
74. Van der Horst.
Which way will he go here? He has two options here. He can go the ball. I would suggest he'd go the ball, because... But he doesn't look to be looking at the ball. Oh, he is. So, it's treble 17, double 8.
76. Anguish.
The single 17 would have left him a go at the ball, so it's a double bowl, that one.
Michel van der Horst does in this, the semi-final, what he couldn't do in the quarter-final. He takes the first leg.
That's a half chance. To Sammy to break Sansi. 100. Goes back to doing what he was doing in the last leg. Starts off with 100.
Michel's finding the trebles a little bit easier to come by as well now. And he's found all three of them this time.
Those smooth darts of Michel's, they slide along one another. You get darts that have got grippy grooves like... Those Carreras there of Sami Sansi's, and they can hit the barrel and bounce off of one another. But Michel's smooth barrels just seem to slide by one another, and there was no more perfect explanation of that than that 180 there. They were all on a pinhead.
They were pretty tight. 100. And the 180, followed by his last three, have put him in control here. Against the throw as well. 45. And we saw in the quarterfinal, Sammy Sansi wasn't really put under a lot of pressure from Paul Coughlin. Now he's got some. How will his new outlook on darts, as you were talking about earlier, how will that fare? Quick look down to see the score for Michel van der Horst here.
He's stolen the darts, van der Horst. Sammy needs a treble there. So the darts are still with van der Horst.
No laughing matter, young lady.
No. Keep your hair on. Great last. That's when you start to think things go against you. As an opposing player. He'll be in now. So it's treble 20. He'll stay there. 42. And that last just the wrong side of the wire.
And again, van der Horst just walks up on Dart Bosch. Game is going well here. And Michel van der Horst, it's completely the opposite to his quarter final here.
78. Just about to say he was in command, and then he just had two looseners. But retrieved it.
Well, he's got a touch of breathing space. Doesn't want to give too much space to Sami Sansi, who seems to start every leg with a decent ton. But again, Michel van der Horst, as Scott is saying, has his eyes set on lakeside here at the moment. He's got his eyes set on a place in the final. It's, remember, the first to six in this one. 99. We're talking about his smooth darts. He's coming across as a bit of a smooth character, Michel van der Horst, and he's just flying here.
I'm sure I know Michael, Michel is sponsored by the Oranje Bar back in Holland, one of the well-known dart playing pubs. I'm sure they're there watching him live on Eurosport, supporting him.
54. Hello to all of Michel van der Horst's viewers at home, and to any of the viewers tuning in here to this Romanian International Darts Open. Sancy breezed through the quarterfinals. He's finding himself up against a much stiffer opposition. Michel van der Horst just the wrong side of the wire with those two.
That's unlucky, isn't it?
See the shake of the head as well.
Yeah, he had to come out. He had to come out from there. For the 64 anyway, so. Now then, he's got to start on the 19, Sammy, here.
And that wouldn't have helped when he walked up, thought about it, then just had to stop again.
He'll stay there.
91. Again,
good setup, but is he going to get back?
Last dart really helped him out there. This time, I couldn't do it first dart. But he does his second, finishing it. He's nigh on impeccable.
Lethal on the doubles. Scoring for show, doubles for dough.
I was wondering how long it was going to take you to do it.
140.
That's better from Sammy Sancy. Not that his 100 starts in the first three legs have been anything to scoff at. But he's thrown a 140 and the challenge is now down, and Michel van der Horst really can smell a place in the final. Another treble 20 on your screens here.
We can see the pace of the game changing here. Michel's throwing a little quicker. 60. And Sammy's coming in behind him and throwing a little quicker.
Straight down the middle, though, from Sammy Sanzi. Can he match them? He has with the second.
Surely.
Just underneath with the third. Sanzi now puts himself in the spotlight for his first leg of this semi-final. And with van der Horst here on 2-4-1, Scott, Sammy Sanzi will know he's got a bit of space here.
60. But you mustn't think it, because the minute that you think you've got a bit of time, it bites you on the backside 9 times out of 10.
100. So you require 80.
Van der Horst doing what he can. Double top for the first leg of the semi. 3-1 with the darts, though. He's now going to do what Michel has done and steal one back at some point. Well, they say you can't touch this. Don't touch your dial. Don't touch your remote.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Fifth leg is Michel Ferrari first. Game on.
So, Michel van der Horst starts with a 60, and let's hope, for his sake, that's not a bit of a nerve and a bit of a shake from Sammy Sancy getting his first leg of this semi-final. And of course, Scott, Sammy Sancy starts with just around about a ton. Second dart here for Michel van der Horst has hit the deck. Sancy will see that, will smell the chance of a second leg.
100.
Well, Michel would have hoped that the break would have then stopped the surge of Sammy. Terrible time for Sammy to have a break. We were talking earlier about the breaks. He just got on the ascendancy, sort of won a leg convincingly, straight out with a double. He would have wanted to have been turning around and chucking his toe on that hockey again and throwing again. So, 100. But it doesn't seem to affect him as so much. He's come back. He's doing what he was doing before. Hitting the lipstick for fun.
97, 100, 100. What's he got here? Straight in the treble 20 again.
100.
Three straight 100s from Sammy Sanzi. It's not blowing the world away, but it's hard to compete with somebody who's as solid as that. And Michel van der Horst just says, hang on a minute, I want some of this. I want some of this action.
But the darts are still with Sansi to turn it. That 180 was just to catch up.
41. Look of disgust on Sammy Sansi's face, quite rightly there. Had a chance.
So, 10 or 6, I can't see which one he hit.
66.
He hit the 6.
Sammy requires 63.
Will he go the traditional route, treble 13? Nope.
Let's go on that route. Double 3.
67. Sammy requires 36.
We've had a lot of non-common routes, and it's catching the camera guys out, unfortunately, but it's not catching Michel van der Horst out.
It's mainly to do with what the guys feel more comfortable with. I mean, some days you're hitting double 18, so 56, you go 20, double 18, and another day that you can't hit it, so you're going 16 for tops. You just change your route, change the route to whatever your feeling works on that day. And I probably honestly think it doesn't. There probably isn't a lot of line of thought that goes into it. It's just that you've hit double 18 a couple of times. Well, I'll leave that again. Seemed to work last time.
First number hits your head.
And absolutely.
And matches the maths I'm in front of you. And guess what Sammy Sansi's doing? He's hitting the hundreds again, back to back at the start of this sixth leg. A sixth leg that's pretty important, though, Scott. 4-1 down here.
A must-win leg, you would say. A must-win leg.
100. And he is again doing everything he can. But Michel van der Horst in this game has found a little extra every time he's needed it.
Not sure he had a little quick glance at the score on TV there, and I don't know why he did that, Michel. 100. After two darts when he was way up on 300.
And again, a bit like the last leg when he found that 180 at the right time, he's found that 140 at the right time as well. Sansi going all over the board for his 46. He's left himself 55. And the horse, treble 20.
114. So he
requires 55. So, which route is he going? 19s or is he going? He's gone 15 for double top.
To keep himself in it. And you see the fist pump from Sammy Sansi. The big Finn, conqueror of Lobanascus, Durrant and Coughlin is still in with a chance of conquering van der Horst as well.
All three you're going to see at Lakeside as well. So what a little scalpy run to have.
87.
That was the lowest start to a leg that Sammy Sansi has come up with.
And that still wasn't bad.
that was the next thing I was thinking.
100.
And he goes back to normal service straight after.
Almost turn the throw right round here, Sammy. Needs a treble to turn it round. So Michel will see that as an opportunity, and that's right on the wire, but he's got another one in there. Almost got it back. Really needed a ton of ton 40 to steal the throw back after his bad start.
That last dart of van der Horst was fractions away from putting a real damaging blow to Sammy Sansi. Sansi, 85.
Nice finish.
60.
Are we about to see a worldie? Treble 20, treble 20 pull. Oh, that's not what he wanted.
Yeah, we're talking. That's what you call a dart, a DOD, a dart on dart bounce out that. Hasn't really hit any of the wires, hasn't hit anything like that on the board. hit each other, took the pace off of it, and then the point didn't dig into the surface of the board.
130, trying to compose himself, and that's not something he's been struggling with. And here you see it, really giving himself a talking to. That's what he wanted last time.
He'll stay there.
He's got it.
Double five. Game-changing moment. Game-changing moment.
Sigh of relief from anybody following Michel van der Horst, watching the TV or here. Because he's still got a chance.
Double top.
62.
Oh, bit of a lurch and a bend of the knee there on the way in. So this now makes this double five big, big time important. He's going straight at it. One above, one below.
Santi back in it. 4-3. First to six here in this Romanian International Darts Open. And Michel van der Horst, now he has to go into a leg thinking, I nearly had that. I nearly stole that back.
I'm just, you know, these are the times when... Is Michel thinking about these ranking points? Is he sort of been in front and then all of a sudden comes back to haunt you? He's still in front. Santi now has the darts. Gone off with his customary ton, which we... I mean, that's as regular as me having bacon and eggs for breakfast.
You can write it, can't you? Here comes Sammy Santi. Oh, I bet he gets 100.
Dunk straight in.
Any betting people out there? Sammy Santi returns to the board. Look at the person next to you and offer them some money. On Sammy Santi getting 100, but van der Horst is doing his bit as well to make this exciting. It is at the moment.
Michel's waiting for a slip, and is this it?
57.
It is.
So a ton here. We're putting points-wise back level.
57.
Which he knew that when he goes to throw that. You know that you need that. And the arm will go a little tight, and the elbow goes a little stiff.
59.
And Sammy knew that he got away with it, so then tried not to make the mistake again mentally, and he made it. Come on, guys, stop thinking. Just lob him.
I used to work in a place, and there was a sign on the door. It said, take brain out before entering. That's probably quite fitting right now. They need to stop thinking about each other and do what they've been doing so, so well. There it is.
100.
Oh, look, that one was going to fall out. I thought he was going to have to run to the ball to keep it in. So, Michel, in trouble 65. Now. We're looking back at it and thinking, 85. This is going to go 4-4, is it?
The phrase Sorry. Clutching at straws or going for bull. Either one of those would have fitted.
That's there, so double top. Second out, double top.
65. Oh, in
the moment. He's been successful there in the past. 60. This is a long shot. But he's capable. He needs another one alongside that. And it's double top for van der Horst.
Oh, just outside. A remarkable 160 finish to stop Santi from levelling it up. And again, Sammy Santi, who have been watching in the background there, now knows he's got three darts to square this up. From a position he didn't think he'd be in a couple of seconds ago. It looked like van der Horst had an amazing finish in him. He just missed it. And that levels it up again.
24.
He started badly. Started badly as well. So now Sammy knows his customary ton will turn the leg round straight away.
And there it is.
It's like he's got a blowpipe. He just throws it into a pipe or something and it just goes straight there, like on a piece of string or something.
45.
Oh.
His head's going. Michel's head is going.
A real turning point here.
100.
I'm not going to tell you what he got. Michel van der Horst needs something. He looked awesome in the first few legs here.
He's now catching the flights. He's now getting deflections. It's now not going his way. This is when you need to be mentally strong.
99.
Well, as close to the regular 100 as Sammy Santi was going to get. Michel van der Horst, nothing is going right all of a sudden in this leg shot.
He, He's missed the 160. So he's feeling, well, that was hard lines because that was right on the wire, and now he's just having no luck whatsoever.
From being a fraction of a weight to making
45.
Possibly, I think, the biggest checkout we've had here 42. So far this week, or so far today, should I say. And now, all of a sudden, he's a million miles away from competing here.
16.
Santi has got all the time in the world here.
We mustn't forget those lakeside positions riding on this game. 16. There are people around the mark of making it in. The results here could make a difference to other people. He's gone the ball route.
69.
Michel van der Horst, 3-0 down in the quarterfinals, fought back admirably and got himself a semi-final berth. He started the semi-final like a rocket. He was impressing myself and Scott here in Romania, in Bucharest. He was looking like booking himself that lakeside spot that Scott keeps telling us he wants. And, well,
wow.
Sammy Santi's walked up, completely lost where he is, and has again allowed Michel a chance.
He went for a 5 and hit a big 20. So Michel has half the deficit, but is he going to get back? So he's happy with that now. It's double 4.
Setting himself.
One outside.
9.
One very well inside. So this is a chance he wouldn't have expected to get.
At some point, this tournament will be straightforward.
Nah. So double 16, isn't it?
78.
Yes.
Some of you require 4.
Now you're thinking, as a player, I could have hit that 160. And I now could have hit that double 16. I should be shaking hands here, having a glass of water, waving it at the crowd and going. But he's not. He's still sat there at 4-4.
First to 6 here. Agonising at 4 apiece. And Sammy Santi, for the first time in the semi-final, Scott, has the lead.
But it's just 4 points. But it's double 2. And the fact that it's double 2, it's changing the game. And now Sammy has the darts.
Game on.
Whoa, something happened there. I think a bit of music came on.
I think the music man...
It wasn't tense enough. Let's just throw a bit of music on and throw a spanner in the works. Let's see what happens
There's
here.
There's always time for Kings of Leon, although it's not the time for Sammy Santi not to throw 90-plus in his first set of darts. And he's done it. Of all the time, Scott, to not throw your standard around about 100. That wasn't it.
This is what this blinking game does to you. Honestly.
A madness of darts kicking in here in Bucharest. 87 for Santi. Some sense of normality at least. Michel started with a ton.
You could just see his arms tightened up, Michel. He's trying and trying and trying so hard. And it's rather than him making that trouble go in there, he's just kind of throwing it with a bit of hope. We've all been there.
And the big man puts in a shift when he needs it here. And Michel, well, I don't want to say his head's gone, but Scott, there's not a lot else you can say here.
No.
He's got to try and recover.
When you get beat, we're still a long way away from that, the way that this game's gone. But he will come off if he does get beat and wonder where it went, and it'll be where... when you lose it on the board, that's a different story, but when you lose the game in your head, that's one that takes a week or two to get over.
It's a kick in the shin, and the kicker is you've done it yourself.
Correct.
Look at this man, 140, knife twisted, placing the final just about booked here.
He gave Sammy a sniff, and he's taken a whole snort. So it's double 8 for the match.
Fill your boots. All the time he needs here.
Double 2.
Double 2, yeah. And he's taking it. 260. Michel needs to get a big score here, just in case Sammy Santi's nerves get the better of him with 4 left.
99.
Leaves.
So it's back to those
finish.
Little 4 points again.
Well, a big scream from Finland's Sammy Santi. And it was a horror story towards the end for Michel van der Horst. He will want one of the masks from the crowd. He'll want to put it on and hide behind it, as you said, Scott, for a little while. At times, Sammy Sanzi, he hasn't beaten Michel van der Horst. He's beaten himself. He was agonisingly close to a wonderful 160 checkout, and from that moment, nothing went right for him. Nothing at all. Sammy Sanzi, 20 tons. He was Mr. Consistent at times in that game. Mr. Consistent will make his way to the final here of the Romanian International Darts Open. We're going for a break, and we're going to ask ourselves, just how did Michel van der Horst not get through there?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the 2014 Romanian International Darts Open, coming to you here in Bucharest. And we continue our semi-final here over the best of 11 legs. And welcome to the stage, first of all, an international from the Czech Republic. It is Michel Ondo.
Michel Ondo. Michel will get to the bottom of it one day. He nearly said oh no at one point. He was 2-0 up against Gary Elliott of Northern Ireland in the quarterfinals, and all of a sudden Elliott was back in it at 2 apiece. We went for a break, and it was as if Ondo had completely changed. He came back and whitewashed Gary Elliott. He took all three of the legs to win it 5-2. He will need every bit of those last three legs when he faces his challenger in this one.
We now introduce an England international. He's the former Lakeside world champion. It's Scotty Tuhotti. Scott Waits.
Scott Waits, and we're not writing an excuse here. He's suffering with a cold, he really is. We saw him after his last match with Kim Verheyen, where he had a bit of a scare from a very cool Kim Verheyen. I spoke to him just afterwards, and he said, genuinely, I just can't breathe at times. Well, it's a good job he knows how to throw darts in his sleep then.
There's just probably a few people out there probably happy if he didn't breathe sometimes, I'm telling you. Like a good friend that I am, I let that out.
That's the third moment, I think, of your friendship with Scott Waits that's been pushed towards the boundary. However, Scott Waits, we said before that once the quarterfinals were read out to us after the last 16, we looked at it and thought, yeah, there's nobody here that should stop Scott Waits. Kim Verheyen impressed, beyond impressing sake, and at one point we thought he might do it.
Indeed, I think Ondo could actually be in a very similar position here, because he wouldn't have expected to come here and get this far this weekend. He's come here and played outstanding darts. Anything from here in his mind is a bonus. So he'll probably, hopefully, for us and the viewers at home, that he plays the game that he'd be so relaxed, and then Scott could be back in the same problem as he was with Kim. And let's not forget, Michael has beaten everybody's favourite Welsh refuse collector this week in Martin Phillips.
Ondo gets us underway then. And that is the sort of nerve-settling first dart he would have been praying for as he walked up.
100. It is how you think. It is how you think. You go up, just want to hit your first treble 20 as quickly as you can to settle your nerves and make it feel, make yourself feel at home there again, particularly when you've played one already.
And actually, when we go back to that quarterfinal, that's exactly what was wrong with Scott Waits for the first couple of legs. He just didn't throw like Scott Waits. He didn't look like himself, and he doesn't feel like himself because of this cold. 39. However, he fought back, and here he is in the semi-final facing Ondo, who's got off to a good start.
Yeah, no, he definitely hasn't been himself this week, and he had two half rolls of tissue stuck up his nose when I came in the other night.
That's a look.
After it is a look and a shot that I really should have got for Facebook, but there we go.
proper mate wouldn't do that.
Oh. 44. I think you've let yourself down, actually.
I've done nothing that he wouldn't do to me. I can assure you of that. I've done far less.
85.
He's in there now. And after nine apiece, he's just in front. His weights. Early doors reverting to the Southport here.
Yeah, I was going to touch on that. I was wondering how long it would take him. And he's getting success again from it. We saw him do this in the quarterfinal against Elliott. After Elliott had pegged him back to two apiece before the break. On 40 there from Waits. After Elliott had pegged him back to two apiece, all of a sudden Ondo reverted to going to the 19s, and he's done it again successfully.
96. Scott, you require 86.
Chance to take this first leg hit.
50. Mitchell, you require 127.
Has Ondo got a 127 in him here?
He sure has, so it's treble 17. It's now the bullseye.
So close to the start he wanted. He was already halfway down the running track with Usain Bolt to celebrate on that one.
Waits, make sure. Calms himself down, lets the man get on with what he's doing.
Wiped his nose.
I think the technical term there when somebody misses a double and then you clean it up behind them, I think you wipe their eye, I think they call it.
Well, he's sniffing. You can see him near it. But that's not to be sniffed at. 180. Wait. Puts the burners on. What's Ondo got?
42.
Well, it's strange. Ondo would have been thinking how he was going to beat Scott and just relax and concentrate on his own game, and unfortunately Scott hasn't allowed that to happen. He's come in and absolutely bossed
99.
It for the first leg and a half.
180, 99. Complete control of this semi-final early doors is Scott Waits. Is he going to be too hotty for Michael Ondo?
Good recovery.
65.
Scott's using gold darts now. He used to use silver ones. New little line of darts that I think Wimmer have brought out for him. He's only just recently 96. Swapped to him, so he'll be pleased Scott out while he's playing with him.
157.
Just outside the treble 19.
97.
Ondo, 306 left here. You see a bit of anger in Ondo's eyes there, and that's not going to help you, is it?
No, but everything's been going right for him so far today. And then there's also the shocker walker into the steamroller that currently is Scotty Too Hotty. It's probably something that he hasn't experienced before. But we'll gain from it.
Learn from your mistakes. He's back up top again and doesn't mess about changing. And now he's getting success that end of the board. So on 40. He walked away from his last three darts with his head in the sky, looking up at the ceiling here. It's a very nice ceiling, it has to be said. It's
I had a couple of looks this week when I was on the stage there. Thinking, yeah, what a lovely ceiling.
Well, maybe he's found some inspiration from the coloured light bulbs in the ceiling here at the Intercontinental Hotel, because he's found another ton.
He's got to find some from somewhere.
Perhaps the How to Play Darts guidebook is in the sky, I'm not sure, but he's found a bit of a comeback.
I've looked for it many a time, never found it up there.
It's because your roommate's got it under his pillow.
57.
Scott really needs a 60 here.
93.
Or a treble 18.
brings them back. Yeah, brings them back in touch. Then the psychology is you try to break away again.
57.
Waits, finding target to give him 72 when he comes back up, if he comes back up. Rondo again, frustrated, 1-3-1. Left himself 16, but Waits will fancy this to go 3-0.
It's double 18 again, takes a step back, has a look. Double 9.
54.
Now, is that a mistake?
You 16.
Hondo let back in here. And he's wayward.
He went with the first dart, didn't he? He went all the way in with it. That was a karma dart, double 2.
14.
He will know he has been given a huge chance to take a leg against Scott Waits.
A let off. Double 9's always a dodgy one, but you have to go straight at it with the first, because if you're going to break it up, you've got to do it with the first dart.
Waits again shows his ability on a dartboard. He might have took a tour around it. There's 32 museums here in Bucharest, and we're taking a guided tour of the dartboard here in Romania. We really are at times. But Waits has found the target he wanted. And he's straight back at the treble 20.
99.
I'm wondering with this cold whether we should actually be calling him Scotty Too Snotty.
Ba-bum.
I'm here all week.
No, you're not. It finishes tonight.
Well, I've been here. Okay, I've been here all week.
And that's starting to show. Hondo. With a ton. It's a lead of one. But it's the legs he'll be looking at. Three of them. The deficit. But again, Waits just slipping to a sub 60.
93.
And that last dart for Hondo could be pivotal as we head towards the fourth leg break.
Actually, Hondo there is picking up on something that Scott does. When he goes under that first treble 20, he heads off down and then comes back up to the 18. So Hondo actually is taking in what Scott's doing there. He hasn't done that in any other game.
Learning on the job. YTS, yeah. They used to call it, didn't they?
Yeah. £27.50 a week.
How much?
Yeah.
He's in the wrong job.
And he had a good £27 of me mum for keep.
100.
Hundred from Waits means Hondo certainly needs 100.
60. Scott, you require 160.
Oh, we head towards a break here. The darts. And Scott Waits in a very, very superior position.
I think the darts are at a bit of a funny angle there for Scott to try and get under it. And he's moved one side and tried to get under it, and that didn't work, so he slightly went back and then just made a total hash of it.
38.
That was a genuine bounce out. That hit probably where two wires join on the corner.
134.
Without touching one of the other darts, that was the giveaway with that.
Explosive back out of the board.
58.
If Scott Waits can make this 4-0 going into the break, he will have had the explosive start to the semi-final he'd have been looking for. Feeling ill, 6-0 will do him. He would love to get this over and done with as quick as possible.
Well, yeah, absolutely. It seems a sneeze and a breeze for him at the moment.
45. Scott, you require 76.
Talked about these breaks earlier on, and actually Hondo could do with it, and he dealt well with the break he got in the last game.
58.
He got pulled back to 2-all in that one, and after the break he was a different and better player. He needs it again here.
just going with that second dart now there. He's got to compose himself. Straight in. First time of asking. Wait. Hits double nine. And the two players make their way. Well, interesting. One off the stage, one to have a practice, Scott.
Yeah, one out of the heat, I think. You know, it's quite warm up out under the lights on the stage, and if you're not feeling 100%, that will get you.
So, whilst the players have a break, we don't. Scott, touched on it a bit earlier, but for those perhaps just joining us in the semi-finals, what does a break do, positive and negative?
Well, it can be very positive for a guy that's in Scott's position here at 4-0 up. He won't be thinking about anything. He won't be worrying about anything. Michael will be thinking about what can he change to get back into the game, because Scott really hasn't even been out of second gear. You know, he hasn't even reached the mid-revs to change gear because he hasn't needed to. So rather than concentrating on what Scott's doing, which I think is what Michael's doing in this game, rather than playing his own game, I think if he just jumps back up there, starts hitting a few tons, starts hitting a few those 1-3-3s, he can get himself back in this game. But you have to remember, with this man, Mr. Waite steps up a gear.
He is resembling someone related to Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer at the moment. I know the C word is much banned in our household until at least the first week of December, but he certainly is red-nosed. But he's not red-faced, because he's 4-0 up here against Michael Ondo. What could Michael do 4-0 down against the former world champion? He's just got to turn it off, hasn't he?
From this stage, you've got to go leg by leg. You can't look at it and go, I've got to win this one with the darts, that one with it. No, it goes further than that. You go leg by leg, and even if you need to break it down by that, throw by throw to spur yourself on, you've got to set yourself a target. So I'm going to hit a ton here and just try and forget what Scott's doing, and hopefully he won't hit a 180 back at you. You know, it's not slow and steady wins the race, but slow and steady can get you back in and get you a chance, and then you have to start taking those chances to make Scott think.
Well, we've been reminded of how bad some of the 80s and 90s music really was, with a rendition of Hammer Time.
If you'd have been here at the banquet last night, you could have seen how bad some of the dance moves were from that era.
You don't strike me as somebody who's got MC Hammer's baggy trousers or moves, if you don't mind me saying.
Well, I don't mind you saying. When you're my size, mate, you don't get many pairs of baggy trousers.
Back to the action, and that's exactly what 58. Michael Ondo wants to do, and I'm sure he desperately wants to get back to the high scoring ways he found in the quarter final when he dismissed Gary Elliott 59. Of Northern Ireland. But he's finding England's Scott Waites to be a much, much tougher opposition here. 4-0 at the break, 43. And you can hear and see Ondo's reaction there. A groan with his own performance. And again, it's a bit like Michel van der Horst in that last one, Scott, where you said if you beat yourself sometimes, it feels even worse.
Yes, it can. I mean, Scott's just doing a steady average there at 85, 86. He's not having to change gear. You've got to be up in the 90s to challenge Scott. Scott will always go with you, but you've got to be up around that neck of the woods. And at the moment, Ondo is not anywhere near that, and he needs a few more of these to turn it around. And again, you can see he lurched in with the second dart, a little bit excited. He got what he wanted with the first. He has had a good week with his national team and had a good run in the Europe Cup singles. Unlike Scott, who went first bat in that. So it just shows how a few J's changes the game.
Yeah, last 16 in the European Cup singles held here in Bucharest in this very venue. So it's not as if anybody's not used to their surroundings. They've been here all week. Some longer than others. Some more success than others. And Scott Waites at the moment. He's heading towards a final of the Romanian International Darts Open, the fifth edition, as they call it.
59.
I think we thought he was going to get a stiffer test here in this semi-final.
I did. I thought that Michael would even think twice, and he'd just go up there going bang, 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 like he did when he beat me the other day. But this has got to him, and it's just a case of Scott going through the motions.
Well, it's like trying to stop a train with a lump of butter. You're going to get nowhere. And at the moment, 5-0. And Waite showing no sign of letting up. Hammers home a 180. Hammers home just part of the nail in the coffin of Ondo's experience here in Romania.
60. Nice arrows from Scott there. Just condemning the fact.
I didn't expect a whitewash here. I know it hasn't happened yet. And we will, of course, give Ondo a huge round of applause in a few minutes. Barring a miracle comeback. I'll tell you what we'll do, is we'll just shut what I was about to say there and leave it to one side. Because this tournament's thrown up some really random stuff. So we'll hold on there.
He's waited till what looks like it's going to be the last leg to start having a good go at the 20s.
Glad you said that.
It's just... Again, that's a dart on dart bounce out where the dart hits the other flight, takes the pace off the dart and doesn't allow it to stick in the board.
And on the back of that 180...
Oh, double 10.
Oh, magic. Magic stuff.
Absolute.
From Scott Waite.
Absolute class.
Ondo just nods in appreciation at what he's just witnessed, seen, been a part of. He deserves this round of applause, doesn't he? It's been a tremendous week for him here. It's been a tremendous Romanian International Darts Open for Michael Ondo. But we'll see Scotty Tuhotti and his runny nose and his band of supporters. There's the hug from Ondo's girlfriend. He's actually got a few tears as Ondo. He saw a massive opportunity to upset Scott Waite. He'll have to watch the final. Perhaps he and Scott Waite can share tissues for nose and eyes. We'll be back in a couple of moments. It's been action here in Bucharest for an entire week. The European Cup rolled into town. And what a better way to finish it than the Romanian International Darts Open. Scott, we're down to two. We're down to Sami Sansi and Scott Waite. Scott Waite has just pushed aside Michael Ondo. For those that are just joining us, a 6-0 hammering. And he wasn't even at his best, really, was he?
No. He lifted just shy of 90, which is that's no sluggish sort of game, but... the boys that he's played haven't really stepped up to that other than Kim. And so Kim pushed him and made a great game of that. And now Sammy's going to have to do the same. He's going to have to dig deep. He's going to have to find something that maybe he had in the earlier rounds while still playing on the floor. And I think, he's going to have to hit Scott from the off. Because otherwise this could be, again, another one-sided affair.
Best of 13 coming up. There is Ondo, who left the stage looking a little bit upset. Maybe he's been and had a chat with the two girls that escort the players in. That's cheered him up no end.
I did. Work for me.
There's been wigs. There's been waves. There's been wonderful darts. And there's been some wacky spectators.
Yeah, I saw most of those on the dance floor last night at the end of the Europe Cup banquet. It is a real festival of darts, that Europe Cup. It's my first one, and one of the most amazing things I've ever been part of. And sharing the stage with some great, great players.
And a man with a Romanian mohawk as well, don't forget that.
Yeah, it's a little bit different, isn't it?
I'm not sure where I come from in the mean streets of Nottinghamshire. The multicoloured mohawk's going to fit in quite well, but there we go. Little Richard on the stage. Bucharest has put the tournament on wonderfully well. The crowd have turned up and cheered. And it all boils down to this.
Finish international playing in its third world ranking final. Welcome, Sami Santi.
Well, I talked about it earlier. Santi, in the last few years, has reached the last 32 of the Czech, Danish, Swedish, German, and Dutch Opens. And now he's found himself in the final here in Romania. The 40-year-old, he was the oldest of all of the quarter-finalists. The oldest meets the highest ranked here in the final. Scotty Tuhotti waits in the wings to face a man that could finish the tournament a surprise victor.
We now introduce the current holder of three world ranking titles. He's an England international, a former Grand Slam of Darts, Wimbledon World Masters, and Lakeside World Champion. It's Scotty Tuhotti. Scott waits.
He sniffled and sneezed his way into a final here. He started our coverage struggling to breathe, struggling to throw darts in the right area, because he allowed Kim Virtanen to just sow the seed of doubt in myself and Scott's brains. We thought there was going to be an upset. He got past that. He did more than just get past Michael Ondo. He demolished him. Sent Michael back to the Czech Republic with a few tears in his eyes, but he got a rapturous round of applause from the spectators, didn't he?
Yeah, he's been good all week, and that's the thing. People grow to like the way you play and like the way you do it, and he has passion, he has heart, he has, you know, it's just joyful to watch. So he's had a good week. People appreciate what he's done, and that's what our game's all about.
He played some brave darts, wasn't afraid to start on other areas of the board within moments of struggling with the treble 20. He was clear he couldn't do it in that quarterfinal. Came back after the break, wasn't happy that he got a 2-0 lead, brought back down, went down to the 19s, different player. He went very early in the semi-final. I think it was just one leg, and he was down.
Yeah, it was. He actually is just Mikhail just come past us and been pointing to his head and said, you know, his head kind of went, and he didn't quite have the experience for the game. And but he has now, because he's experienced it once, and you can't get experience unless you play in these games. So fair play to him.
Yeah, you talked about him learning from Scott during the game. What he's got to do now is take a step back from this international open and learn from his experience of that semi-final. Nobody wants to get beaten a whitewash.
No, not at all. And people that have been on the telly for the first time today will be going home and watching it and studying it, same as I did. We're not and work out where you went wrong and what you did wrong and analyse yourself.
Sami Santi, well, he threw 20 100s in the semi-final against Michel van der Horst, and he also was in a dodgy position for a while, Santi, and he's kicked us off. He's obviously gone away and thought, I need more than 100 here, and he starts with a 140. No better way to start, is there?
No.
Well, there is a slightly better way, but you kind of get what I mean.
Yeah. I think that'll settle him down no end. Sami has the game to do 90 averages, which is where he's gonna have to do 90 pluses to beat Scott, because Scott steps up to them. And we know that he's been in finals. So what has he learnt from those finals? How has he learnt it? And this is where he finds out what he remembers from them.
We talked about Santi's coolness and calmness when he demolished Paul Conklin in the quarterfinals. He needed every ounce of that because Michał van der Horst of the Netherlands got off to a flyer. And then all of a sudden, you talked about Michael Ondo's head going. Michał came across as well, and he said exactly the same thing. My head just went, and then my arm just went, and then my hand just went. He said, in fact, it just went.
Just every scenario went cuckoo, really. Down in Dorset, we call his head, went in the shed. And he had to get his head out of the shed, and he couldn't do it.
Well, Santi survived that scare by, as we say, kept just throwing solid darts. Those hundreds were racking up, and as Michał fell apart, Santi just stayed right down the middle. Those tons were a steady ship for him, and he floated himself into this final here in Bucharest.
I find it strange. A lot of the foreigners do that by going down for the 19 first on something like a 1-3-3. But you've been thrown at the treble 20 the whole leg. So surely your mentality would be to stay there and try and hit a 60, because you're still then going to have to go downstairs to leave yourself something anyway.
Well, perhaps they think it's strange that we queue for everything.
Yeah, I just don't get it, really. Don't get that. Bullseye,
he's got a chance, and he's taken it. We said it earlier, Bucharest, bonkers for Bullseyes, and Sammy Santi starts the final by giving the crowd a bit of a treat.
There's his Finnish supporters there, and their organisation. And this is what confidence can do for you, a big bullseye. Is now giving him a load of confidence.
He starts the second leg like he started the first. Two 140s to start your legs.
100. I'm sure he stepped his average up with that good finish and those two good starts. It's what he's going to have to keep up through the whole game.
He also did that in the first leg. He threw 140 and 60. He's just thrown 140 and 45. He may rue some of that a little bit later.
Looks like around now, if that the second one goes in the treble.
Scotty too snotty, as Scott has renamed him on this occasion.
Could be worse, he could have chicken pox, he could be Scotty too spotty.
I've left you alone for a couple of minutes to work on those, and that's the best you came up with.
Yeah, yeah. Didn't come up with myself, so there you go. Can't even take credit for that.
Well, it was funny. You mentioned about his cold in the quarter final. He threw a 180. We're mocking him about his cold now, and he's done it again. He's thrown another 180, and that will just remind Sammy Santi of the task in front of him.
It will. It will. Scott has stolen the darts in this leg because he's going there first. So it's the bullseye for Scott.
80. Couldn't replicate what the 40-year-old Finn did before.
We don't have to even be told what he thought of that by the facial expression. So now we're looking at another treble 18. He's missed it. He'll probably stay there.
40. Scotty Rewire, 41. Yeah, you don't need Scotty too hotty to tell you in words when he's frustrated, do you?
No, not at all. So it's double 16. Double eight. Games on the side. Superbly retrieved. He would think that was a lackluster attempt at the ball. He would not have been happy with that at all. And of course, if that was the only dart that he had at it, mentally, if Sammy then had got out, different ballpark.
Yeah, there was a tiny look of relief in his face as that went in.
But he got, it got a bit scruffy, and he got away with it.
Santi will not do his 140. In fact, he doesn't even master his standard 100. So, a bit of a slip here. There'll be a break in this, we're led to believe, after six legs.
46. When you break first leg, the biggest thing you've got to do is then hold your own second. And Sammy would have been disappointed that he didn't do that. That would have been what that was about. And then, of course, he's still disappointed when he goes back to the board to throw his next dart to the next leg.
It's one of the biggest sports for holding your nerve.
Hey, there's no 15 guys to go by with a ball under your arm the shape of an egg. There's no goalkeeper in there to stop you in darts, unfortunately. It's just you and your bottle, and it's that simple.
And we said this earlier, the only person that beats you is the bloke next to you, or yourself.
Indeed. Two scenarios. Both catastrophic when you're on the wrong end of them.
And, we've just seen one of those in the last semi when Waits has just moved aside Michael Ondo, bless him. But at least Ondo was quick enough and brave enough to say that it was his own head that went here. And Sansi, not using his head, he's using his darts to do the talking. He's left himself 86 here with Waits still on 197. Against the darts again?
On that throw, he threw the darts a little bit quicker, Sammy Sansi. I got a bit more rhythm about what he was doing. I wonder if we're going to see him to continue doing that.
Oh, he'd left us rather dumbfounded there. He put himself in a remarkably good position to go 2-1 up against the darts again. And the first two darts were just...
He's going to go tops, tops. Double top again.
18. Oh, nearly punished Sammy Sansi, but Sansi needs to finish here.
Strange decision that. I thought the 60 was wide open, but maybe that's where he felt more comfortable. Probably doing them at exhibitions.
Shouts have come on. Not just from Sansi. He's clearly found some extra backers in the crowd who fancy an upset here in Bucharest.
Well, who fancies starting the leg? There's not a leg gone with the darts yet.
If anybody wants to start a leg well, please stand up now. Anybody can do. It doesn't matter.
Usually the start of the leg is an advantage. We've had three legs, three turns of throw.
There's a sign there that said, "Wife, I'm here." As long as you didn't go out for a pint of milk 5 days ago, you'll be all right when you get in. Look at this from Sammy Sansi. 180.
Throwing quicker, though. Throwing quicker.
Which is interesting because you talked about he looked like he changed his complete style, his complete stance, and he sort of thought about things more, slowed down a bit, and now all of a sudden he's sped up.
But the speeding up will suit Scott because that's the way that he can do both things, Scott. He can play slowly, he can play quickly. Now this is the Sammy that I remember, just picking him up, loading the gun, and boom. And he hasn't done that so far today.
Well, maybe he was saving it because he's got it at the right time here. Well, the standard Sammy Sansi 100 is needed.
Oh, doing the tops, tops.
Well.
Scott would have found that funny. Didn't even break a smile.
I'm sure he's laughing internally. Here. Outwardly, he's getting himself into a position just in case Sammy Sansi misses this double top for three darts. That's one. That's two.
Double ten.
Oh, and he's blown a massive chance here to go 3-1 up. And again, as you said earlier, Scott, will somebody stand up if they want to take ownership of going first?
So it's 20 for Bullseye. Bullseye for Waits.
Oh, it's there.
He's done a Sammy Sansi on Sammy Sansi. Ball finish.
Well, from the very first game, we've said here in Romania, nothing seems to have gone normally. And it's just not. Everything's throwing us some massive surprises. Nobody has won with the darts yet here in this final. It's the final. Ton. The icy stare of Sammy Sansi. And he appears to have left his steady tons behind somewhere. Not happy with himself at all. Taking a moment to look at the floor and reassess things there. Scott Waits.
Nobody taking hold of this leg. 55. Pace has changed to a slightly slower pace again. And then, as soon as I say it, the last two, whoop, straight over the shoulder, gone. That's a good first start. Bit of shoulder there. Bit of shoulder, arm and leg in that one.
Really lurching forward on that third dart
trying
there.
Trying to force it through the gap.
I think he thought it was closing time at the bar. Very eager to get through. Samsey not impressed with that final dart at all. Nor should he have been. Two apiece here. All against the throw.
44.
Satsy fans in the crowd.
Raucous. Raucous nearly.
Well, definitely let them know in some sort of language that I wasn't understanding.
43.
Will it be the language of winners? Long way away from that one just yet, but two apiece here in this Romanian International Darts Open final, live from Bucharest. And we're seeing the 2013 BDO World Champion just struggling somewhat here against Sami Sansi. We talked again earlier about this, Scott. He's already seen off a few decent players in his journey. Labanauskas, Duran.
Well, we said at the start of the game that Sami was going to have to lift his game, and he's lifted his game a little for the first few legs. And then, but he's brought Scott's game back down to his, which is very unusual for Scott to allow that to happen. But that first start in the five.
45.
It's worse than wayward, isn't it?
He's just not getting he's just not getting the first dart line right, and then he seems to be a little disappointed with himself. And this is spurring Sansi on.
Yeah, Sansi's not starting his legs well, but all of a sudden he sees an opportunity towards the end of it, and he was nearly striking gold just then, but he's got to watch the gold darts.
Double top.
Of Scott Waite, just under.
So a missed ball from Sammy. Where's he gone? Has he gone? Oh, he's gone 17 for double four.
21.
And another chance against the darts for Sansi to take it. He's blown it. Big shake of the head from the big Finn.
It's double 10 then for Scott. Double five. He's got two darts in his hand. He has to go that way. Lurch there, a bit of a lurch. It's he's having another look.
Well, he took himself back a second. He had a word with himself, and I don't know what the word was. I don't want to know, but it worked.
He snatched it. There's no other special way about it. He snatched that dart. He didn't mean to do that. He knew that he'd sort of like the nerves or the pressure or whatever the situation. It was 2-2. He needed to get that just to hold his throat for the first time in the match. And he just stopped, calmed himself, went back in, new throw, one dart in his hand. Away it went.
Sansi finds his ton. Waits. Finds a little bit more. 140. We go to a break after this leg.
85.
Oh, that's unlucky. That's a bounce off the flight there. Nice diversion for Scott. A bad one for Sansi.
I was going to say, that depends what camp you're in. When you say a bad one.
59.
Yuri there from the Czech Republic.
I'm going to have to ask somebody less famous than you to come to the commentary box next time. I've never had so many people appear in front of us taking pictures and videos whilst we're trying to look at our notes that we've made and bits of paper, but there you go, we're mastering it.
A picture of me and you, mate, will always keep the pigeon off the lettuce in the springtime. Who needs a scarecrow?
I thought that's what it was for, yeah. I thought that's what it was for. So, 176... and 217 remain.
Oh,
it's 100 from Sami Sansi. You wouldn't believe that, would you, Scott?
No, and it looks like, you know, he's in prime position to hold his leg.
That would be something random.
Another random act of the game.
Some of you require 76.
To do what Waits has just managed to do. Hold his own leg.
56. Rushed the last start there. Rushed it a little. 60. Threw it in hope rather than aim.
If Waits can come up with something special here, it will send Sansi's brain working overtime in the break.
140.
Good last to pressure. So Sansi then, double 10.
And the big man does it. It's all square. Three apiece here in Bucharest. We waited a while for somebody to hold their own darts. They've now both done it back to back. We'll go for a break. They'll go for a break. Where will we go when we come back? Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to all you viewers. Welcome back. Chain yourselves to the telly. Don't be scared. This is the Romanian International Darts Open here in Bucharest. I've lowered myself to your jokes level there, Scott. You've been a bad influence on me all afternoon.
You have. Don't be scared of what you see in the crowd. We want you to be scared of what's happening on the stage.
And it has been scary at times. It's been a little weird. We're three each for Sansi and Waits. It took four legs for one of them to hold their own dart.
59.
Here. 59 isn't the best of starts for Waits after the break. He's been sniffling and snivelling his way through this International Open.
41.
The snatch of the darts there tells me he was not happy with that opening throw. it really is just fits and starts. You know, the total averages there, you know, 81 and 80 shows why it's 3-3, and Scott's dropped at least 15 points off his average in this game. And Sammy's raised his a bit because his last one was in the 70s. So,
60.
But I thought he'd have to raise it a lot more than that.
I think he probably did as well. Remember, he started the first two legs with 140. But he then followed in both legs with a 60 and then a 45.
96.
Peaks and troughs, as they say.
Indeed.
Sansi, 400 on the board. A shake of the head.
60.
Tried to talk himself into a treble 20. Didn't. And now trails by 84.
60.
But Waits can't capitalise either.
They always taught to try not give anything away in your body language when things quite haven't gone your way. And at the moment, these two are like two actors out of EastEnders here. They're giving everything away.
100.
Somebody's going to find Doc Cotton in a minute and it'll all be all right. I'm not sure which one it's going to be, though.
As long as they hit the dot they're aiming at, they'll be fine.
Oh, slightly into the marker he wanted, the grimace on the last dart. And yeah, you are right, these two, their body language and their facial expressions there. Again, the shake of the head from Sansi. Neither particularly happy. And that's probably because neither can pull away from the other.
Or is it kidology? Is Sammy going, no, it's not going to go in. Buff. Trouble 20. I can't work it out.
Well, it worked on this occasion. It didn't work on the last one. We'll keep an eye on his third going in. Oh, well. We won't, because Scott Waits has just bulldozed his way through to a 4-3 lead.
18 dart legs, always good on your throat. Not unbeatable, but it's nice to start from the break.
Sammy starts with a 137 to come back with. Again, that final dart. You see the lips moving, the face drops straight away.
Sammy now seems comfortable to have the darts.
100.
And so he's now on 137, 100. Waits is coming back. He'll move downstairs because that top dart looked like it was going to fall out.
So he goes downstairs and had another genuine bounce out. Probably the genuine bounce outs with this type of blade board is right on the corner, right as the two corners of the trebles or whatever meet. That's when they tend to hook out.
Well,
so he was unfortunate.
Seen a few. And as you say, you take a productive manoeuvre to stop a dart falling out of the board, and you manage to go and hit.
Indeed.
He's happy. Oh,
he's from Gloucester.
Ah, twice happy. Sansi got himself a finish. Triple 20, treble 15, double 8 for the big man. Waits. Has found a 140 and leaves himself the ton, which will put all sorts of pressure here on Sami Sansi. And just maybe that pressure showed that weight ton.
Double top again.
Oh, that's how it's done. We saw Sami Sansi try it a little bit earlier on. We've seen Scott Waits nail it.
One of his favourites on the exhibition circuit. I'm not sure I see that too many times at one of the opens for him. But he won't worry about that. It's work this time.
You have a wry smile when you're saying this.
Because if he'd done it to me, I'd be calling him a cheeky what's-it when he come back. That's what I would be doing. Although it is one of the ways that people do tend to go now. You've got to use all the board. Nothing wrong in it. A few years ago, it was seen as a bit cheeky. But when it all... I find it hard enough to hit one double top. So why go for two? I go get it, but there we go.
When you can do it, and it helps to win prizes.
Exactly.
Then why not? €1,600 before tax. Up for grabs. You came to Romania and won earlier on in the year. These guys looking to take away top prize. And, Sami Sansi will take away a bit of respect from a couple of people who have said to us he's just changed a little bit. As you said earlier, he seems to have just mellowed out a bit and slowed it down a bit.
Had done himself proud this week, without doubt. Scott's fighting very similar to how he did in the pairs this week. He was fits and starts at times, and with pairs you help each other out and you come in and out and help one another, and singles you've just got to help yourself.
At 5-3, Sami Sansi, and that's probably what that grimace was for, will know full well he needs to pull one back fairly sharpish to stop Scott Waits.
It's the sort of range he's been enjoying, and he's done this shot once already before. And he's done it again.
He has done it again indeed. Waits moves to a 6-3 lead. And against somebody like Scott Waits, three legs is a mountainous comeback.
It is. It is. And let's not forget, Scott's been used to winning here this week. He's won the Europe Cup pairs title with myself. And we won the overall team. And we were runner-up in the team game event up there on that very stage. So he's had plenty of action up there.
He's looking at making it a hat-trick of victories here in Bucharest this week. European Cup success, and now on his own in this Romanian International Darts Open, and I'm sure you as his roommate won't hear the last of how he conquered Romania with a cold.
Yeah, and how well he did without having to carry me, usually, I think, is what he says. But those of us that know him know he doesn't really mean it, I'm sure. I wonder if he'll iron my shirt before we go out tonight.
I told him you've mentioned that. Didn't look overly impressed with it. I'll let you two sort that out later. Waits here. 99. So Sansi, who led us off in this leg.
59.
Just hasn't found the rhythm that he's had through the quarters and through the semis as Sami Sanssi.
And we haven't really seen Scott for whack either, have we? He hasn't really need to have been. I mean, sometimes as a player that tends to happen, you play against your opponent in situations like this sometimes. Averages won't worry Scott. Titles will worry him. Putting your names on the gongs. That's what people remember you for.
Yeah, trophies aren't won on averages. If you have to fight out a scrappy final to get a victory, then you have to fight it out. Put your best foot forward. Might not be your best darts.
Indeed, and I mean, here we are at 9:15 in the evening. I know that Scott's first game this morning was at 20 past 10. So it's been a long day for all the players. And sometimes fatigue can set in and a bit of tiredness, and you make mistakes like Sammy's just done there.
Sanssi leaves 32. Will he get chance to go back?
84.
He will.
Somebody require 32. Look, they've taken a shot put there. Got dragged in.
Entire board rattled. Sanssi makes it 6-4. Something to fight for still here in Sami Sanssi, the 40-year-old Finland dartsman. He's back in it. But he's still got to find three more brilliant legs.
140.
And when a superb dart like that last one goes in, that doesn't help your confidence none, does it?
No, not when we're one leg away from the end. I don't think Sammy will give up in any way, shape or form. But we can see there that Scott's just pipping the averages there with an 84 to an 82. But Sammy's first nine, interestingly. 96. We're talking about the Mr. Tum machine that he has become. He's just in front by 4 points.
They're tons, 140s and 180s, though. Absolutely level, as we were a little bit earlier on with these two. Couldn't see who was going to get their noses in front. And it was drippy nose Waits that managed it.
43.
That cold not holding him back too much. But again, a facial expression that tells you he's not too chuffed with that last set. He still seemed chuntering away in the background as well.
Oh, is that a sign for me, do you reckon?
No.
Thanks.
It's all right.
Not a problem.
Part of the Michael Ondo supporters club.
94.
I think you've had your picture taken with just enough people today to keep you in check. Yeah. Sanssi.
He's not going to go away.
He's not at all, is he?
As we're getting to the business end of the leg now. He was looking for two treble 18s there for double 10.
92.
Made sure. Left his favourite 36.
Sammy Sanssi will know that was a huge chance. And he trudges. You can see the trudge.
So 36 for the title. I think he bent the blade there on that wire. Game. That one's in.
Yeah. It's in indeed. Scott Waits will be crowned Romanian International Darts Open champion. We'll be going for a break in a little while. When we come back, we'll see the award. They're happy. We're all happy. Some of us just don't need to wear wigs and bunny ears to show it. Not a final that Scott will consider to be his finest moments there, but you take the victory.
You take the victory all day long. You know, that sums off a good, tops off a good week for him. a good week for Team England that we've had, and it just shows the strength that we still have in the UK with our darts. And but it's been good. It's been good to see everybody. Good to have the family back together for a week. And then off we go our separate ways again tomorrow.
So we're going to take a short break here. The ton machine, Sami Sanssi, wins that battle again, but he was well short of the amount he needed to get anywhere near former BDO world champion. Scott Waites will take the victory here. We'll see him crowned Romanian International Darts Open champion in just a couple of seconds. We're going to take one last break here. We'll be back with you in a couple of seconds. Come back to the coverage of Romanian International Darts Open, and alongside me, Scott Mitchell has just been looking at some of his social media stuff, and Scott Snotty Too Spotty was one of the favourite tweets that we saw him a couple of moments ago, and he has complained of having a cold. And to be honest, when you talk to him and when you look at him, you can see he's been struggling. He was complaining of not really being able to breathe much after his battle with Kim Vähänen of Finland. But he's not done a bad job, has he?
No, he's done all right. It's mostly me that he's been keeping awake anyway. He can't hear himself when he's asleep. But no, he's done a brilliant job this week.
Mr. Angelo Zucana. We are going to bring on stage, first of all, our runner-up. I did mention it was his third world ranking final. It wasn't third time lucky, but what a day he has had here in Bucharest. Come on, let's hear it for our runner-up, Finland's Sami Sanssi.
I think it's fair to say there was nothing spectacular from Sami Sanssi all the way through any of the rounds. It was methodical, and you even pointed out that he seems to have changed his style completely. Slower, more concentrated, and he got him all the way to the final.
More positive. It just seems a more positive throw, and one that he's more comfortable with. And fair play to him. You know, it has improved him, given him a bit more strength on the board. And no, he's done very well today. He'll enjoy that. He'll know that he's had a good day when he gets home. It's hard as soon as you've lost to then go watch the winner go and pick the check up. But he'll take a lot from what's happened to him today and this week at the Europe Cup, and take stock and move forward again.
And we now present our champion. It's his fourth world ranking title of the season, taking his total of BDO world ranking titles to 19. He is the 2014 Romanian International Darts Open Champion, England's Scotty Too Hotty, Scott Waites.
I'm sure the cold will hit him now that the adrenaline has stopped.
Yeah, that come down, it's not
exactly.
Nice, is it?
No, it's not.
The euphoria, as you say, will last a few more minutes. He'll get his check, he'll get a handshake, he'll get a trophy as well. And he'll get a few minutes to enjoy it. I'm sure his roommate and the man alongside me, Scott Mitchell, will help him celebrate the... They love Romania. We've enjoyed it. We really have. He's enjoyed it more, though. Scott Waites. €1,600 with a runny nose. That's plenty of money to get some tissues. So we head towards the end of our coverage here. Thank you very much to Bucharest. 37 museums, 22 theatres, 18 art galleries, 3 concert halls, 2 opera houses. Only one Scott Waites, though, eh?
Indeed, today, that's been the way.
Waites has led the line. We looked at the quarterfinal draw, and you just said to yourself, who's going to stop him? Kim Vähänen had a heck of a good go at it. Michael Ondo, on the other hand, was brushed aside. Just couldn't find the form that he got past Gary Elliott with. Sami Sanssi had been confident, calm and collective as he made his way into the final. but there's no matching Scott Waite's. Whether he's fully fit or not, he'll find a way. Enjoy the rest of your evening. From myself, Alan March, from Scott Mitchell alongside me, this has been the Romanian International Darts Open. Scott Waite is the champion.